continuing the tradition.
Here he goes. See you later. He's got a hand on the record. Touchdown!
ABC Sports Championship Television.
They are like thoroughbreds bolting from the starting gate. These BYU receivers seeming to flash across your vision. And there's always been a Gatling gun quarterback to throw the football to them, picking and choosing among the scattering catchers. This football season doesn't seem to be any different, but for the record, you should know, tonight, the Hunter is different. He's a big fella. They call him a Trojan. And he's got some lofty ideas about filling his loiter with cougars. USC roaming off to a hinterland last week, handling all the elements to tame a tiger, casting aside any suggestions they might not travel well without their horse. Tonight, the truncheon-toting Trojans of USC host the elusive Cougars of BYU on ABC Sports. From the historic Los Angeles Coliseum, college football makes its presence for 2003. As usual, September is a hot month in Southern California, but we got lucky today. It was only in the 90s, offering up a comfortable evening for those who have come to the Coliseum to see this first ever meeting between the BYU Cougars and the USC Trojans. Both teams won their openers against teams from the South. BYU beating Georgia Tech, USC shutting out Auburn, and the Trojans made a big jump in the polls. And here come the Trojans for their first home game of 2003. They're ranked fourth and fifth in the major polls. And there are a lot of people around Los Angeles and Southern California who have lofty ideas for them. But we'll see. This could be a mud hole tonight. Dan Fouts with me, along with Todd Harris on the field. I'm Keith Jackson. And Pete Carroll said to his Trojans, "We have only just begun," to quote an old song. Don't get cocky. And you better not.
Keith, this game could turn into a real numbers game. You've got this great SC front four. BYU may have to throw the ball 60 times to beat them. That means the Trojans will drop seven into their pass coverage to stop these five wide receiver spread offense. Keith, no matter how you add it up, this could be a classic matchup.
Southern California's quarterback has started one ball game, and BYU's defense is like a crossword puzzle.
Keith, I think this may be the time for the wraps to come off young quarterback Matt Leinart of the Trojans. This is a defense that actually invites you to throw the ball to the wide receivers, and that means this man, Mike Williams, could have a huge day. 81 catches as a freshman last year, eight more last week at 6'5", and speed to burn, Keith. He's a guy the Cougars have got to keep their eye on.
It could be fun if it turns into a run-and-gun show, and it could. We'll go to John Saunders and Terry Bowden at Times Square Stadium right after this break.
Starting with me, everything in this place is mean and miserable.
Is that a tear in your eye, Private? Do you want your mommy? Are you going to cry?
I'll kick the tradition and chivalry out of you.
I suggest you shut your mouth.
I can't hear you!
Nothing is over until we decide it is!
Just one more thing. Don't ever make me mad.
Sweet dreams, ladies! Cradle up, right now! Ha!
There's more to protecting your family in the summertime than knowing which sunscreen to use. You've got to make sure they're protected at home as well. And no one helps protect families better than ADT. A single ADT system can help protect your home and family from burglary, fire, and carbon monoxide. Call now and take advantage of ADT's summer special and get ADT installed at a price you can afford. You could even save up to 20% off your homeowner's insurance. ADT, always there.
All right, listen up. A lot of people depend on you for good communications, gentlemen.
That's right.
So get out there and give me 110%!
Come on! Do it! Do it! Do it!
from 36 to the Baker residence ASAP.
Go in for Johnson. Go deep.
Let's go, people. I want to see excellent coverage out there.
I want truck 85 to set up here. I want truck 93 to come around here, break left, and set up right here.
Proud sponsor of College Football Saturday. Los Angeles, California, and the USC Trojans finished the season as the second hottest team in all of college football last year. BYU coming up, John Saunders alongside of Terry Bowden. And if you had some advice for USC, it would be afraid, be very afraid. They're ranked number 5 this week. But 5 teams already in the top 25 have come up on the short end of the stick. NC State, Virginia, Auburn, Purdue, and Penn State, all losers. It's tough to get your teams ready for these teams that you expect to beat.
Well, John, the limitation on scholarships has made so much parity in college football that any team can beat another team on a given day. But you're right. When everybody's telling you you're supposed to beat a team, that they're a cupcake, it's hard to get your kids mentally ready to play.
That's what they're telling USC.
Yeah,
that's
you know
what
they are. Heard you all know along. They are, but they aren't. They throw the ball very well, and many think USC has the best defense in the country. They stopped a strong Auburn running attack last week, but they're going to be tested in the passing game today against BYU.
A lot of aerial action in that game. We'll see it at halftime, and we'll have scores and highlights throughout. Right now, let's join Keith Jackson.
The sky remains almost white hot as we in the Coliseum, those gathered here having a moment of respect for the young man from Southern California who's coming here to play football this fall and surfing. And they are not going to use his jersey number, Dreon Rucker, his name. They'll not use that number 54 this season. Southern California's head coach Pete Carroll in his third year here. He remains the defensive coordinator, and Norm Chow coordinates the offense. Now we go to the field for Todd Harris with BYU coach Gary Crutton.
All right, thank you, Keith. Coach, you have the ominous task of bringing the Cougars to the Coliseum for the first time. Did you see many wide eyes as you came in here today?
You know, it's a wonderful place, and we're excited to be here and looking forward to getting going.
Where do you think this game turns?
Well, like I was telling Keith Jackson and Dan yesterday, that as soon as we get up there, we just pop them in the face one time, just let them know we're a physical football team. That's where I think it's going to turn.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck. Well, I'll tell you what, Keith and Dan, the streak for BYU is still alive. 351 games since they have been shut out. The good news is none of these players were alive when it happened. The bad news, the last team to shut BYU out completely was Arizona State back in 1975. Keith?
All right, Todd, thank you. Ryan Killeen will kick off. BYU will have the football first. David Christensen and Reynaldo Brathwaite are waiting for it. Brathwaite is going to be the tailback tonight because the man who was supposed to start last week broke a bone in his foot, and he will not play for a while. The kick is well back into the end zone, and Brathwaite's coming out with it. He was 5-6 yards deep in the end zone, and he gets out to around the 18 before he is thrown down. So the BYU Cougars come to the lineup. Matt Berry, the quarterback, is a sophomore, has 7 games as a starter, coming off his 2-year mission. He's 6'5", threw 46 passes in their 24-13 win over Georgia Tech. He completed 31. He'll have an evening, I think, of quick decision-making because the Trojan defensive front figures they can put pressure on him, just the 4. If they can, that leaves the linebackers to roam around. He gets it outside very quickly, and the receiver splits and goes between the tacklers or defenders, and Chris Hale has picked up about 11 yards. The Outback Steakhouse starting lineup now for BYU. The backs and receivers, Toby Christensen and freshman tight end Daniel Coates, each caught 6 passes in the first game. A total of 8 players caught passes. Farkas Whalen, the tailback, as we noted, will not be able to play because of the broken bone. The offensive line, this is perhaps the group that will determine the fate of the BYU Cougars tonight because of that kind of defensive pursuit by the Southern California Trojans. They're able to get penetration, and Brathwaite goes down for a slight loss on the play.
Keith, this is really going to be, that was an example of if you hesitate, you are had. And Brathwaite hit the line of scrimmage. Nothing was there. He bounced to the outside. And that's where that great pursuit of this front 4 and these fast linebackers of SC take over.
Ty is in the ball game now as the Cougars go to a shotgun. Matt Berry at 6'5" has good vision. And he squirmed back inside the 25-yard line. Udazi, Kenichi Udazi, in on his second tackle already tonight. The front four figures to be about as good as anybody's. They shut down Auburn's running game. They tormented the quarterback there. Cody and Patterson can tear up an offense. Linebackers Lofa Tatupu was a tornado last week at the middle linebacking spot, and Simmons and Grootegood are well-tested. This unit in the secondary, true freshman Darnell Bing at strong safety, sore ankle, but he doesn't play like a freshman. Will Poole is out there right now in the secondary for Southern California. Berry has time, throws on the money. Ball bounces off the shoulder of the tight end, Daniel Coates, and Coates was wide open.
Yeah, but I wonder if he might have lost this ball in the sun. If you take a look at the shadows on the field, the ball was coming directly out of the sun, and that hit Coates right in the chest. Normally, he makes that catch easily, and if he catches this ball, it's going to be a first down. Look, he's looking right back into the sun. I don't think he ever saw the ball.
Matt Payne is in the punt on fourth down. Kevin Arbett standing back at his own 30-yard line. The kick is away. He didn't get all of it. Arbett comes up to the 35, accepts it, and goes to the 40, and that's where it'll be USC ball. First down and 10. The starting quarterback for the Trojans, Matt Leinart, sophomore, won the starting job over four others, steady outing at Auburn. It should be noted, though, the defense delivered him a short field most of the day, and he has yet to lead a long, consistent drive in a close game, though he has shown great poise. And here comes the first snap of the ball game now with Herschel Dennis lined up as the deep back and three wideouts for USC. Leinart stands quickly, left-handed throws, and there's nobody home. Incomplete forward pass for Mike Williams. Let's go off to New York now. Update from John Sunders.
Keith, didn't take long for the Canes against the Gators. Opening kickoff. Devin Hester fields it, sees a seam, and gets through it quickly. And then you just kind of wonder, where are the Gators as they try and run them down? 97 yards, kickoff return for a touchdown.
Wow. Second down and 10 for Southern California. Thrown to the sideline very quickly. The ball is caught, and the advance is going to be about 4 yards for Big Mike Williams. Williams is 6'5", 230-pounder. The Outback Steakhouse backs and receivers. This is a very strong group. Kerry Colbert, a four-year starter, has 140 career catches. And, of course, Williams at 6'5", 230 is a load and bigger than anybody in the defensive secondary for BYU. The offensive line healthy, or the most health they've had in a good long time. And this is a very good group. If they give their quarterback time, he'll sort out the BYU defense. Loop down the sidelines and over the head of Mike Williams. Not quite available because the defense was pretty good that time. Chad Barney covering Williams on the play, and the Trojans will have to punt. There's the BYU defensive line. Papingahi is something. He just endless energy and bounds all over the place. The three linebackers are quite good and can run with almost any wideout. And your defensive secondary, they will gamble. There's no timid people in that defense for BYU.
Now you saw RK, which is right cat, LK, left cat, and CGR, which is cougar, the whole animal kingdom in the backfield.
A new vernacular. It's a low punt fumbled, and the Trojan jump on it. It's Southern California football at the 21-yard line. So he came up to receive the ball, and the coverage downfield as the ball bounced off the return man, Melvin Simmons, was all over it. It was David Christensen, and it goes right through his arm.
Yeah, a little jitters there by Christensen. Normally a sure-handed punt returner. That's why he's back there. He's courageous, and he's got great hands. But watch his head. He looks up just as the ball comes in low, and it goes right through the basket. You can see that SC is excellent in the turnover ratio department. They have four already this year on the plus side.
So first down at the 21, Dennis the single back. Leinart back to throw the ball, goes down the middle with it, and finally completes a pass to Mike Williams. He threw to him three times, one short completion and two of them over his head.
Well, last week, SC shut out Auburn. Turnovers were the key. Kevin Arbett tips the ball to Darnell Bing. The swarming SC defense forced and recovered two fumbles. Matt Grotegood and Lawan Ramsey with the play. Look how many Trojans are around that loose ball.
Reggie Bush, a freshman, 190-pounder from Spring Valley, California, checked into the backfield. Leinert looking to throw the ball, had no chance to do it. Colby Bakbo blitzing down the middle, buried him. That's what BYU will do to you. They come up and set up in a 3-3-5, and then they run to their final position just as the quarterback is trying to sort out and figure out who's going where.
Well, what they try to do is dictate to the offense where the hot receiver is. But that's just poor pass protection that time. Four from the weak side outnumbered the SC blockers. But we'll get into this rather unique defense of Bronco Mendenhall's later.
Leinert gets heat again, gets away from one, still looking, throws to the end zone, and it is caught down at the one-yard line by Kerry Colbert. Sure-handed Kerry Colbert. 141 career catches for him, and he runs brilliant routes. He's always easy to find if you know the book.
Yeah, and he gets extra time to work as he's going to go down and then across the middle. Watch Leinert come out this way, keeping his eyes down the field. Colbert gives him the high sign, and the ball's on the one-yard line.
Buckbolt was the man in the backfield, chased him out, but couldn't catch him. So it's first and goal from the one for the Trojan. Ball is handed to Dennis. Dennis is racked up. The Cougars having nothing to do with running the ball down their throat. They close the door on him, and down at the bottom of the stack was big old number 77, Daniel Marquardt, a 315-pound sophomore from Vista, California.
Last week, SC had those three turnovers we talked about. They turned them into 17 points. But sending Herschel Dennis at 190 pounds, I bet he's more like 175 up the middle, may not be the best idea.
Dennis is the deep back. Leinert looking to throw it, rolling out, pressure coming, throws, touchdown. Mike Williams. Mike Williams got the first touchdown pass last week. It was the first pass ever completed or ever thrown actually in college competition by Matt Leinert, and he gets the first touchdown today.
At 6'5", Keith, he's such a big target, obviously, but he's quick enough to find the openings in the secondary. That time just worked along the line of scrimmage, got into the end zone, and presented a beautiful target to his quarterback.
Ryan Killeen for the point. Tom Malone, the punter, holds it. The kick snapped through. And Southern California jumps out to the lead of 7-0 here in the first quarter of play on a warm evening in Los Angeles.
Room service. Your grape nuts, sir.
It'd take four bowls of grape nuts to get the B vitamins in just one bowl of Total.
That's a manly breakfast. Your raisin bran.
10 bowls to equal the zinc in Total.
I'll keep the gym open. Your special game is
40 bowls to equal the calcium in Total.
Late checkout this morning?
You need Total. It's got 100% daily value of 12 vitamins and minerals. No other leading cereal comes close.
Bowl of Total,
I'll
please.
Take Total.
Kitchen's just closed.
Total, Total Raisin Bran. One bowl, 100%.
FedEx. FedEx. Hello.
FedEx Express. All you need to know when shipping to Asia.
Hey, hon, how are you? We're good. You know us, up at the crack of dawn, right on schedule, no fooling around. In fact, gotta go, real busy here. And Dip says hi.
You kind of have to know.
I feel like I kind of do.
Picture mail that talks from Sprint. Now at Sprint stores, get great deals on a wide selection of PCS Vision picture phones starting at $99.99. Share it when it happens.
Coach Gruden was so happy we won the Super Bowl, he told us we could take the first Sunday of the season off. That's because we're playing on Monday Night Football.
Bucks, Eagles, Monday night on ABC.
7-0, Southern California jumps out to the first quarter lead over BYU. Used the turnover and cashed it in from 21 yards as Christensen fumbled on the punt return. The kick by Colleen has got some air under it, hanging and hanging, and 2 yards deep in the end zone. Here comes Brathwaite. Brathwaite's out across the 15 and short of the 20 at about the 19-yard line. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right. Nissan and your Nissan dealer. SBC, ordinary people, extraordinary job. And Miller High Life. To live simply, proudly, boldly, manly, this is the highlight. On the 19, here come the Cougars now with Vatapuna, the single back in the backfield. Matt Berry drops straight back, looks, throws quickly down the middle, passes incomplete. And I'm guessing the would-be receiver was Toby Christensen because he was the man closest to the pass, but he was a good 3 yards from it.
The problem that SC presents to Matt Berry and this offensive line is obviously the talent level of the front four is excellent. So that allows SC to just drop the rest of the secondary, seven of them, back and to flood these zones that BYU is trying to flood with their five and four wide receiver sets.
Brathwaite goes in motion, backfield is empty, Berry looking around and throws, and the ball is caught by Rod Wilkerson, and Wilkerson is up to the 27, maybe exactly the 27. Grootegood made the tackle for Southern California, so number 26, a junior out of Orem, Utah. I think everybody under 25 in Orem plays football.
Well, and he uses pretty good strength to get inside of Arbet, but that ball was thrown the only place it could have been thrown by Matt Berry, right into the breadbasket of Rod Wilkerson.
It is third down, a long one for the Cougars. Lacapuna goes in motion. Berry's going to throw on third and short. Delivers the ball sharply to Justin Jory. Jory's got a first down. Move the chains up to about the 38-yard line for BYU. This is their kind of game right here. A little dunk here, a little dink there, and then all of a sudden, bam, down the field it goes.
Real good combination right here. You got the tight end coach here. Watch Jory coming to the inside here. It's just a five-step drop real quick by Matt Berry. As Jory finds the opening right behind his big tight end coach.
Berry turns, gives the ball away. Brathwaite will hit it across the 40, close to the 42-yard line. Tackle is made by Tatupu. That's Mosi's son, Lota, who came from Maine when Mosi was living back in New England and finished his playing career and began coaching. Lota went to the University of Maine because they were one of the two schools that offered him a scholarship. And then after a year there, and he won't admit the snow did it, but the cold weather, but he started shopping around and said, I don't think this is where I want to be. Second down and seven. The ball is thrown to the sidelines. It is caught, and it's about the line of scrimmage. Kukahiko made the catch. Kukahiko is a junior. He's also from Orem.
And we're seeing what this BYU offense is all about. Gary Croton says that the philosophy here is to have a wide open drop back game that stresses the short to medium pass routes. But he says we also have speed in our wide receivers that may surprise the SC DBs.
It is third down. Ball goes down the middle. It is tipped and it is incomplete. Reaching up to get a hand on it. Tatupu again, and here's a penalty flag. And I think this one's against USC. It was thrown by the back judge deep in the field in the action following the ball being batted down. The referee is David Skutaya. It is a Pac-10 crew.
Heck of a job by Tatupu to get real deep.
Dead ball foul, personal foul, defense, 15 yards, previous spot, automatic first down.
So a personal foul, and their personal fouls usually are pretty silly. And obviously Pete's concerned about it because it is a big foul here.
This is Tatupa. Watch him get back deep in the middle of this two deep coverage by SC. This is real good athletic ability and recognition. There's the penalty right there. A shot to the head by Marcel Allman on Toby Christensen. Or rather, David Christensen. He's having a rough night.
Yes, he is. It is a first down. The ball's on the Southern California side of the field at the 43-yard line, and the defensive front asserts itself that time. And Omar Nazel jumps all over Matt Berry and takes him back to the 44.
And you may wonder why would BYU run an option play like that one. Well, what that does is it does put some doubt in the defensive end's mind later on in the game. They can't just tee off and rush the passer. They got to say, hey, they ran that option. I've got to respect that first and then get after the quarterback.
Second down, 11 from the 44. Berry swings it out to Tahi. Tahi's got some room. He's down at the 35-yard line, and that's 2 yards short of the first down. BYU coach Gary Croton, in conversation with us, had this comment about the USC defense.
Such speed on the defensive front. Their defensive front was just so fast, and they just are relentless getting to the ball. And I you know, that's anytime you have a defense that does that, they're going to be a good defense.
Gary played his college football at Colorado State. And Berry back. Looks right, looks left. Pressure coming down. He goes back at the 43-yard line. Omar Nazel, the defensive ends for Southern California. Udeze and Nazel are tough customers. You just don't give them any room or they'll run right up your backside.
You said he looks right, he looks left, down. He goes, you can't be looking left. Against the speed of this front four. Look right, let it rip.
That's right.
You don't have that 4 seconds. You don't have 3 seconds against this Wild Bunch 2 outfit.
And it brings up fourth down and 10. In the punt, Matt Payne. Matt's first kick, 39 yards. He wants to pooch this one, kill it deep if he can. They'll let it bound, and it goes into the end zone. So it'll come out to the 20 in Southern California's ball. USC leading in the first quarter of play, 7-0.
Up your night for Outback's legendary Bloomin' Onion and our center cut filet.
Hey, John, how's work?
Working as we speak.
Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
On September 26th,
give me the rundown.
One movie takes adventure to the extreme.
I hope you enjoy the fall.
Let's go.
Heads up.
What?
Like a little birdie up there. Caw-caw, caw-caw.
Great.
What is he doing?
The Rundown.
Establish dominance.
Rated PG-13.
Some opportunities are too good to pass up. The Nissan Sentra.
Here's tonight's Coca-Cola salute to the fans.
You reckon he sleeps in the house?
Let him off the leash.
Yeah, I bet he's quiet when the game's over. Reggie Bush now is the deep back for Southern California. They take over, first down at the 20-yard line. Here's that 3-3-5 look on defense. They give you And everybody takes off and goes to another spot. And they give the ball to Bush, and Bush trying to get around the corner. And he runs into about five white shirts. Next Saturday, join ABC Sports for a college football regional tripleheader. Starts at 9 Pacific, defending national champion Ohio State against North Carolina State. Buckeyes just barely got by today. Arkansas will play Texas. And at 12:30, Notre Dame, which just barely got by today against Washington State, takes on Michigan. And at 5, you've got Illinois, UCLA at the Rose Bowl and other regional action. Check your local listing. That's a lot of football, and we've had a lot of football today, too. Might have turns, hands to Bush, bounces, and then bounces right into the arms of Colby Bakpo. Colby gets his third tackle of the night.
Well, we're seeing the effectiveness of this Bronco Mendenhall BYU defense. They want to use movement to confuse the quarterback, but also the offensive line, and they want to be offensive in their approach to playing defense. In other words, make the offense confused, make them tentative. As you saw that time, the freshman, Reggie Bush, had nowhere to go when he came up to that line of scrimmage. Timing is critical, Keith, for this defense. They will move just before the ball is snapped, but we will see SC counter that by changing the snap count, either going quick, as they did that time, or long.
If you guess wrong, though, your pocket is picked. Leinert runs out of bounds up around the 23-yard line, and a Cougar follows him out and takes him down and draws a yellow flag. So Bockwolt in pursuit, overly aggressive, way out of bounds on the Trojan quarterback. That's a personal foul, 15 yards and a first down. How will the defense have to play? Well, you've heard something about the new vernacular from Bronco Mendenhall. Let's let him define what he wants from his defense.
There has to be risk. There has to be illusion, and there has to be disruption. Otherwise, it will just be a long night, and we've done nothing to stop their flow and their rhythm. And so to think that we're going to play the game without risk would be not an accurate statement.
Risk, illusion, and disruption. I thought I was talking to David Copperfield.
Maybe he's a disciple. First down, the ball is up on the 38-yard line, and it's Bush going in motion. He gets the ball as he goes by, and he's got some daylight. And he's up to the 45-yard line. We picked up 7 yards before James Allen, a junior from Inglewood, which is just down the road from the Coliseum here, makes the tackle for BYU.
Well, this is what a normal 4-3 defense looks like. Two corners, a free safety, and a strong safety. And then when you take a look at what BYU does, three down linemen, three linebackers, and then these different initials in the backfield. The key is the Cougar man right here. That is Aaron Francisco, and he is the key man on this defense, where he goes.
Second down and 3. Stand up, pop to the sidelines. First down, penalty flag down. Mike Williams at midfield.
Pass complete to Mike Williams.
Let's see about the penalty.
That's the other part about this defense. It invites the quick short throws to the wide receivers. We've already seen 3 or 4 such passes to Mike Williams already in this first quarter.
And he's big enough and stout enough to break a tackle. And it's against the Cougars.
Williams has 3 catches for only 11 yards, but he did get in the end zone.
So they were offside on the play. Put the ball right on midfield, accepting the penalty and make it first down.
Here's Francisco right here. Leinert sees him, and he's going to throw the ball to the outside, where you see the cornerback on that side. Gennaro Guilford is about 10 yards off Mike Williams. That won't hold up.
He's playing with a rubber cast. Here comes the blitz. Ball is in Leinert's hand. Gets it away. Good to Colbert. Colbert is tracked down at about the 48-yard line on the Cougar side of the field. I mean, they were coming from everywhere. Mike Tanner was the man all over the Trojan quarterback.
Yeah, let's take a look at this pursuit right here. You can draw up any defense you want, but if you don't get 3 or 4 men to the ball after every play, you're not going to be successful. That's what Mendenhall is banking on, along with all that illusion and disruption, is effort.
You got a double tight end alignment now. Dominique Byrd and Greg Gunther in for Southern California. Big people, and Leinert's pass down the middle of the field is should have been intercepted. It was intended for Bird, and Dominique couldn't come up with it. And a BYU man had the ball in his hands and could not hold on.
John Burbidge, who intercepted a pass last week against Georgia Tech. In fact, he intercepted two. One was called back because he interfered with the receiver, but that one there was a difficult catch, but he did read the defense, and Leinart, real lucky he didn't throw his first collegiate interception there because he was late delivering the ball to his tight end.
Burbidge actually had it, I thought, and then went down, the ball rolled out. It's third down and nine as Leinart stands. The penalty flag is thrown. Ball caught by Colbert. Colbert's got a first down and going to the end zone. But let's see about that flag. Laying on the field right at midfield. Hold on. It's touchdown. The penalty's against BYU. Gary Colbert. Split defenders on a sharp pass from Leinart and took it in.
Looks like Colby Buchwaltz was offsides on that play, trying to draw the SC offensive line offsides. Two mistakes by Buchwaltz in the same series.
Well, they're ganging up on Mike Williams a little bit. That opens the door for Colbert, and Colbert's good. He's been good for 4 years. Ryan Killeen, Malone Hole. High snap. Oh, good. Kick good. At 2:43 to go in the first quarter, it's Southern California 14 and Brigham Young nothing. The temperature now getting down into the high 70s.
Here's a lesson for the would-be Casanova. Every so often, it's advantageous to remind the little lady she hasn't dropped off the radar. Well, well, well. 2-1, you'll be living the high life tonight.
Were you in a major accident?
Are you a lemon? You smell like a lemon.
Carfax has the history of the car you're looking at. Get a Carfax report from your dealer or go to Carfax.com and get the truth about used cars.
Hey, which never-ending pasta you guys get?
Penne. With Alfredo sauce.
Spaghetti.
With the meat sauce.
Fettuccine.
With pesto.
You guys play tennis today?
Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl, just $7.95. Pick one combination of sauce and pasta, then another. Have all you want.
Wonderful.
Wrangler 5-star premium quality denim. Wrangler, real comfortable jeans.
One team.
Who the hell are you?
One mission.
Their job's to keep us safe.
Stop any threat.
Nobody finds out. You got a problem with that?
No, sir.
Threat Matrix, ABC Thursday, September 18th.
The Nissan drive summary, 8 plays, 80 yards, took 3:23 to chew it. The USC drive was extended by a big personal foul by BYU on the sidelines against the quarterback. It would have been fourth down had the foul not occurred, but it wound up a 48-yard touchdown reception for Kerry Colbert, and they still haven't run the ball with any consistency.
Three rushes that time for Reggie Bush for 6 yards, but Matt Leinart's red hot.
Lee knocks it beyond the field of play, and it'll come out to the 20 for the Cougars. Two clashing cultures become one big happy family. It's all relative. A new comedy coming out Wednesday, October 1st, 8:30, 7:30 Central on ABC. Got the coolers going down below. It was up into the middle to high 90s today over much of the area. Yesterday, a lot of places were over 100 a minute. I think Palm Springs today was something like 108, 109. Have to wear your shoes when you go outdoors.
That's
to. First down from the 20-yard line. Out of the shotgun, Barry stands up, throws the ball down the middle, and it's dropped by Toby Christensen. That big 6'5", 220-pound Barry, when he lets it go, he's got some sauce on it.
Yeah, and he can be decisive if he gets back quickly and recognizes where the holes in the secondary are. But he's got to have his receivers bail him out. You can see he can, as tall as he is, see right over the top of the defense. That ball has got to be caught by Christensen.
Intercepted! It's touchdown! A big ugly gut one, Omar Nasel. The head coach is the defensive coordinator.
And he has some great athletes with which to coordinate. One of them being Omar Nasel.
Killeen for the point. Good.
Nazel's no stranger to interceptions. He's got three now in his career at SC. None that will make him more happy than that one that results in a touchdown. Watch as he comes on the pass rush, the cut block by Brandon doesn't get him on the ground. This is what we mean about the athletic ability. Boy, the ball thrown right to his shoulder. Not a juggle at all. Now he's showing the ball and high striding into the end zone.
Hey, mama, look what I found. Floating in the evening air, in the gloaming yet. 21 to nothing. That's a big start.
Well, and again, it's another turnover, and that's what Pete Carroll preaches to his ball club. You win the turnover battle, you win the ball game. Right now, they're in total control because of two turnovers, and that one the defense took in by themselves.
When the defense starts scoring touchdowns for you, life is good. For Brathwaite, and he'll go out of bounds at about the 25-26. Pete Carroll's comment to amplify on what Dan just said about the preachment on turnovers.
I've found that, you know, if you really do a great job of emphasizing things, you get results. And that's our number one theme from the first day I got here, and it always will be. And I think, you know, the numbers, I'm really proud to tell you, that kind of bear it out, that over the 2 years, you know, we've been here, I think we've the best turnover ratio in the nation.
Got a new quarterback in the ball game now for BYU. Freshman John Beck, 6'2", 190. Tahi's in the ball game with him, turns and hands, and Tahi goes no place.
This is always a great place to be putting in a new quarterback. What do you tell the kid when you're down 21-0?
But well, this it can't help but hurt, but it can't do anything but good for Matt Barry to come out and have a little look at it from the sidelines, it would seem to me.
Well, and this is what they did last week against Georgia Tech. This is part of the plan. At some point early in the season, John Beck is going to get a series or two.
Second down, 10. Ball is actually marked out at the 26-yard line. That's almost a face mask grab, but Beck gets away, and he gets his britches dirty as he comes up to about the 33-yard line. Nasel almost got him. Omar's having a big night, but it was almost a face mask, and I think probably he realized that he couldn't grab because he would foul.
Pretty good strength by John Beck. As Nasel with the right hand couldn't bring him down, but there you are. Five turnovers forced already this year, and off those five turnovers, 31 points by SC.
They're down and three now. BYU needs something good to happen for them. Beck's pass whipped sharply to the tight end, Daniel Coates. And that's good for a first down at the 45-yard line.
And that's where they're going to have to work the tight end Coates over the middle. He had six catches last week against Georgia Tech, former wide receiver, so he has that type of skill as far as his hands are concerned and his movement.
Yeah, but by playing tight end, he gets to eat biscuits and gravy. He's up to 249.
Yeah, that's his body, but his mind says, hey, I'm a wide receiver.
First down from the 45, Beck back. Pressure coming, gets it off again, throws it in the ground. He let it go, trying to get the same tight spin on the ball. Apparently he did before, but Grotegood was coming right up his back. Matt Grotegood is a 215-pounder, 5'11", not the biggest guy in town, but when he hits you, it doesn't feel like it's a small truck.
No, he played a linebacker position, has great speed, and one of those motors that never stops running.
Second down, 10. Beck looking around. Again goes in the middle of the field, and it is incomplete, intended for Toby Christensen. He's a senior, and Jason Leach came over and whacked him.
Well, that's two big hits early in the year now for Jason Leach. Last week against Auburn, he took some guy's hat off with this similar type of athletic move. Ball thrown well to Christensen in traffic. And again, the BYU receivers are letting their quarterbacks down by not making the tough catch in traffic.
Look how many red shirts were around the receiver.
Five people.
Wow. He would have been pummeled if he had made that catch.
Next pass, kind of a sidearm motion, penalty flag comes out of the field judge's pocket.
And we got a foul call.
Yeah, he's thrown to his tight end, Daniel Coates, who may have been held on his way to that route. What I like about Beck, though, Keith, is he's getting back and letting it go. Very little hesitation.
He rips it on there, doesn't he?
Yeah.
We told you Dave Kutai is the referee. Linesman, the umpire is Doug Wilson. Head linesman, Bob Beal. Manuel Alonso, the line judge. They accept the penalty for roughing the passer. So they'll move the chains and get a first down out of it. The side judge is Roman Petkovicius. Field judge is Dan Spriesterbach. And the back judge is Michael Aronian.
Michael Patterson with the late hit on the quarterback. A good step and a half too late.
Big Mike and Sean Cody, what a pair of tackles those guys are.
They are wreckers. From the 40-yard line, it's a scrum, no gain.
Very little room there for Tafui Vakapuna, 6 foot, 230-pound freshman. But you're going to see a lot more of Vakapuna in the game rather than Brathwaite, because you got to keep him in there to give the quarterbacks added pass protection.
Quarter's over. Ball placed down right about the 40-yard line. So after one at the Coliseum in Los Angeles, the Southern California Trojans are dominating, leading 21-0 over BYU.
The all-new 265-horsepower Nissan Maxima.
Introducing Taco Bell's new spicy chicken burrito. It's a little spicy. Taco Bell's new spicy chicken burrito, packed with shredded chicken, simmered Mexican spices. It's tasty, filling, and only $1.29. To get your fill of this satisfying thrill, think outside the bun.
Hey, It's 5:37, and if you're not home by now, get ready for some traffic. I-5 southbound is backed up to exit 222. Look for delays on the Banfield, and Sunset Highway West has cars.
Well, I think the outside is sometimes a reflection of what's inside, but ultimately, you know, what's really important is the dirt you can't see. Like some gasolines will leave dirt on my intake valves. That's why I like a gas that helps keep my my engine clean and running well, like Chevron with Tecron, because otherwise the outside doesn't matter much, does it?
Help keep vital engine parts clean. Chevron with Tecron.
What can one do?
If you've been injured in an accident,
commercial. So, what's for dinner?
Remember that cute little pink blouse that I was telling you about the other day? You know, the one with the famous pink somebody in the turkey pot pie.
Fast forward your wife and skip recorded commercials.
Wow.
Now you can get a free Dish Player DVR from Dish Network with up to 100 hours of tapeless recording with free installation. Visit Radio Shack, Sears, or a local participating retailer. Or call 1-800-WOW-DISH.
Steve Dunn and Natalie Marmion, weeknights at 5 and 11 on K2.
The aerial pictures of downtown Los Angeles, courtesy of Goodyear's newest blimp, Spirit of America. It's based down the road in Carson, California. Goodyear built the first blimp back in 1925, currently operating three of them. The Goodyear blimp. When it's in town, you know something's going on. Beck. He's still looking for some daylight and can't find much. It'll be third down. Here's another penalty flag. And it happened over there. Came from, I think, from the field judge again.
Might be Melvin Simmons getting tangled up with the BYU tight end, Daniel Coates. They both got tangled up.
Yeah, foul is on BYU. Let's go off for an update from John Summers.
Keith, it's the BCS Spotlight game presented by ADT Update. Florida and Miami. Ingle Martin, a quarterback, finds Carlos Perez, who somehow is wide open completely. 50 yards for the touchdown. Florida and Miami answering each blow tied at 10 apiece.
The, what do they call them? The Crockett Gators are having something to say about it, huh?
Yeah, and let's see what that penalty was all about, Keith. Daniel Coates, number 20. There's Melvin Simmons with a headbutt to the chin. Coates didn't like that. And that right hand there, you can't throw a punch. Everything up to that point was semi-legal. You know, I think the headbutt to the chin may not have been so legal, but you can never, ever throw a punch. A lot of penalties last week against BYU, 16 of them.
And it's third down and 23. Beck throws a sharp pass, and that catch is made nicely by David Christensen.
Yeah, they say the ball hit the ground as he
came
as
out,
he came
he
down.
Failed, yeah.
Yep. Close. A horrible first quarter for BYU. This is going to be way short of the first down anyway, but you can see never had control.
Never had it. No.
Trying to squeeze his elbows together before he hits the ground.
Matt Payne, Kevin Arbett waiting back at the 10 for USC. No pressure. That gets it away nicely. It's over the head of Arbett and reaches the end zone. It'll come out to the 20. 14-14 remaining in the first half of play. You're watching ABC Sports Championship Television.
On an uncharted island, 12 fierce competitors have gathered for
the Capital One Mascot Island Challenge.
We've separated America's favorite mascots into the polyester and wool blend tribes. First event, Iron Mascot Marathon.
Cast your vote for the National Mascot of the Year at CapitalOneBowl.com. Tune in the Capital One Bowl to see who wins.
One thing that can break up any party? A broken chip. Get Tostitos Gold. The Tostitos that are made extra thick. Perfect for hearty dips. Tastes so good, you never know who'll show up.
So, guy goes into a bar.
Tostitos Gold. The perfect chip for hearty dips.
Explosive out of the four-point stance. The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul.
price, little expenses. Another good reason to keep your car around. That's why at 75,000 miles, switch to Valvoline's Max Life. Its added ingredients help prevent wear on critical parts.
Hello, gorgeous girl.
At 75,000, time to switch to Max Life.
Spicy garlic shrimp, fire grilled chicken, and our famous baby back ribs. Chili's Fajita Trio. Want more flavor? It passes better than a West Coast offense. The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul.
New season.
Same rules.
Excuse me, these are my daughters.
Eight Simple Rules returns Tuesday, September 23rd on ABC.
Southern California leading 21-0. Troubled Gary Croton there, discussing the problems of his team. USC needs just four wins to become the 10th Division 1A team to win 700 games all time. That's a lot of games. Ooh. Starting field position has been all theirs tonight. Look at that, 25-yard difference. Run it from the 20-yard line on first and 10, and the gain is negligible for Herschel Dennis. Dennis is a sophomore out of Long Beach, California, and everybody behind him are freshmen.
True freshmen.
Yeah. There's a handful of them, and they're all good.
Yeah, Reggie Bush, Lindell White, Chauncey Washington, Whitney Lewis. Great competition in practice. Boy, it's practice fun to watch around here. There's Reggie. He'll see some action. Dory has three carries in that first quarter.
Second down, still about 10. Liner throws, pass complete to Greg Gunter, the basketball playing tight end. And he'll get it up to the 26-yard line. So it'll be third down and a long three.
Leinert's doing a good job of reading this defense as he's dropping back to pass. Because of it's such an unusual alignment they present at the line of scrimmage, it's tough to get a pre-snap read. So the way they counter that is just by going with a quick passing game and trusting what you see as you drop back. Now, five wide receivers for Leinert.
Five. Backfield is empty. Cougars coming. Can't get there. A little quick pop over the middle goes to Justin Wyatt. Justin has a first down for the Trojans at the 34-yard line.
That's giving your opponent some of their own medicine. That looked like BYU, what they like to do. Spread the field, spread the defense, and throw the quick pop to Justin Wyatt. Steve Sarkisian knows all about this offense. Former BYU great quarterback, working with Norm Chow, former great offensive coordinator for the Cougs.
For 27 years. This is Dennis, and he cannot get away. The tackle is made by Popinga.
Time for our Pacific Life game summary. Three touchdown passes so far in the first half, two conventionally. This 1-yard touchdown pass from Liner to number one, Mike Williams. And then Kerry Colbert on a slant route goes 48 yards for the touchdown. Now the interception by Nazel. In fact, that ball looked like it might have been a backward pass by Matt Berry. 21-0 Trojans.
Mike Williams has been quiet of late. Leinert looks to the sidelines, throws the ball low. The catch is made after the 40-41 by Justin Wyatt. Justin is a sophomore from Compton. It'll be third down and three.
See, Leinert checked the game clock as he came out to the line of scrimmage. Play came down from Norm Chow to Steve Sarkisian. Then to his quarterback.
Leinert throws quickly. The ball is dropped. Dropped by Whitney Lewis, number four, a freshman who was sounding off a few days ago about not getting any action in the Auburn game. Somebody very firmly said, shut your mouth, Whitney, get in shape and come and play. When you're in ready to play, we'll play you. So apparently he's been working at it.
Now he's got to work at those hands. He also plays a little wide receiver, so he has versatility. Just a little over-anxious here at that time.
Well, he's a big kid. He's a big guy. He's 225 pounds.
That's Malone. Beautiful kick. Into the end zone. Both these punters had a very good start on the season. That's a 59-yarder. It'll come out for BYU to their 20. First down.
By out-accelerating, out-handling, and out-performing the competition, the Grand Prix Comp G earned Pontiac the right to become the official performance machines of the NCAA. The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul. The persistence of 135 years of experience. The performance that has enabled us to work with more than half the Fortune 500. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life.
A few of us had actually never built a set before, so there was a learning curve involved.
When working in television, lighting is important. Now, the best sets are your basic Western frame with open sight lines.
Yes. So the audience can see us, and we can see the camera.
Exactly.
Can I use a jackhammer?
There were times when it looked like everybody might not be on the same page.
When LA's newest cops hit the streets,
now come down here.
The streets won't know what hit them.
I told them to take the stairs.
10-8, ABC Sunday, September 28th.
Her parents are
homos, Fruit Loops,
a sissy lumberjack.
His parents are
Irish Catholic,
baboon,
Republican nightmare.
The battle rages on.
I blame Clinton.
It's all relative. Coming out ABC Wednesday, October 1st.
The cooling machines spraying the coolness about. Matt Berry is back into the ball game now as the BYU Cougars come up to the 20-yard line for a first down. Trailing, though, 21-0. Berry's first go-around, pretty rough. Let's see what happens this time. Ball is thrown, completed to his tight end. And Daniel Coates, who is a freshman, will have a first down up across the 30 to the 31.
Here's our Pontiac high-performance drive summary. See the great field position. This is BYU's first half. Terrible field position and terrible results. John Beck didn't play poorly in his four passes, only one complete, but he had two dropped.
Berry, little play action, throws. That's a good catch. David Christensen went up just behind the defender and made the catch. And he's right on the marker for another first down.
But it appears that Matt Berry's got the message on the sidelines, get rid of the ball. Find somebody quickly and deliver the ball. Those last two passes thrown on time without hesitation. And the Cougars have got some momentum going.
Did they win? I didn't know they win.
First down, 41. Berry back, throws. Looking for some help. Catch is made by Brathwaite coming out of the backfield. And he gets up to about the 47. And we're off to visit with John in this update.
Keith, thanks a lot. Oklahoma against Alabama. Jason White, remember a year ago he got hurt in this game. 46 yards to Mark Clayton. Don Shula is looking on watching his son coach this game. But he had a guy named Mark Clayton who was doing it for him, not against him. 13-3.
Oklahoma, of course, the top-ranked team in the country. But the one sitting out here wearing the colors of USC is evolving.
Yes, it is. You wonder about the Buckeyes and if they'll drop below SC if this continues tonight.
This is Brathwaite out of the backfield on the little swing pass. Gets up the midfield. He's going to be a yard short of the first down. And Mike Patterson, the tackle, and let's spend a moment with Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, the folks at USC aren't going to want to hear this, but is Brathwaite as good as Marcus Allen? Well, apparently in high school he was. He tied Marcus Allen at Monte Vista High School with a 300-plus game, 7 touchdowns in one game. Now, that was in high school. We'll see how he does here against Marcus's Trojans.
That was in Spring Valley, California. And Marcus did all right, didn't he?
Yes, he did, all the way to Canton, Ohio.
Third and one. Brathwaite. Didn't make it.
You got to stay behind your blockers. If you're going to have any chance at all against this SC defense, go where the play is designed and not back into the pursuit with all those SC jerseys.
Yeah, he ran into Kenichi Udizi, and down he went.
Marcus Allen's number 33. One of 5 Heisman Trophy jerseys adorning the peristyle end of the stadium.
Classy guy he is. Sure is. I think maybe the coaches are saying to young Brathwaite just exactly what you said. Follow the big fellas in white. That's a high, very short kick. And it takes the BYU bounce and then rolls around inside the 20. So he gets it down inside the 20, and that always helps. ABC Sports presentation of college football is brought to you by Pontiac, official performance machines of the NCAA. Circuit City, we're with you. Pacific Life, offering insurance, annuities, and investments. And new Tostitos Gold, the perfect chip for hearty dips. When you've got Tostitos, you got a party, baby. Yard line where it's first down for Southern California. 21-0, Trojans in command. See the total offense numbers there. That tells you. Ball is thrown out to Mike Williams, and Williams gets a block on the corner. And Mike is across the 30.
And you notice Matt Leinart went with a long count that time. SC had 4 wide receivers in the game, and Leinart took his time, let the defense move, knew exactly what he had. Here is Williams, and the swing will come out here, and the block will get to the inside, which will send him down the sideline. Good teamwork there. Both wide receivers out there in front. Colbert with the key block that time.
Colbert and Smith. And it's first down at the 35. Leinart's pass down the side for Mike Williams. Can't get to it. That was very good, very well defended by number 4, Gennaro Guilford. He's from Hawthorne, California, which is pretty close to here, and playing with a rubber cast. Another update with John Saunders.
Well, Keith, Florida, Miami, we've seen just about everything. Brock Berlin against his former team, of course, the Gators, looking for Frank Gore. That's a lateral, folks. And Keewon Ratliff picks it up and takes it to 34 yards for the touchdown. And the Gators have a 16-10 lead. A botched extra point where they had a fake, didn't get it.
My goodness. Wouldn't the Gator folks have a hoot? They won that ball game? Ooh. Herschel Dennis on the carry.
They might have 2 hoots.
Need a bus to get him home. Well, they've been giving Ron Zook the business down there, and I'm not sure he deserves it. They just like to give people the business in the wake of the old ball coach leaving town to go to the pros. Ball is on the 36-yard line. It's 3rd down and 9 now for Southern California. And you got 4 wideouts. And the pass is thrown to Mike Williams, and he's beyond the marker. That's the first down. So move the chains up to about the 48-yard line.
SC having all kinds of success throwing the ball. Leinart now 11 of 16 for 130, a couple of touchdowns, but running the ball has been absolutely nothing for SC. But why run it when you can throw it to athletes like Mike Williams and Kerry Colbert? You saw the good coverage on the play previous by Guilford, but that time he was too deep and playing inside shade, and Williams still got inside him for the first down.
I don't know. I still kind of got that old-time philosophy tucked under my hide where I believe running football teams are tougher. Oh, that's a lateral pass. It's thrown wide to Steve Smith. who figures to be a very good one. He is a true freshman out of Canoga Park, and he is just short of his first down. Solberg made the tackle. Thursday, September 18, we invite you to meet a team who, under direct orders from the president, has only one mission, and that is to keep us all safe. A new drama called Threat Matrix, Thursday, September 18, 8, 7 Central on ABC.
And Keith, because that was a backward pass, as you noted after talking about tough running teams, that was the longest run for SC to a wide receiver, 8 yards.
Chauncey Washington is in the backfield now, so the freshman running backs are all getting a little taste of things. And timeout is called by Southern California. Time remaining in the first half, 6:45, and it's 21-0, Trojans.
Football town, I know my team needs me.
And without my voice, the game could be lost. In football town,
I know it can make a difference. This is
my game. I know fans can win the game. I've seen it. I've felt it. I've tasted it. I know. You make the game.
Get up.
Explosive out of the four-point stance. The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul.
You want to know the secret to winning? One has to rig the game.
It was supposed to be the perfect crime.
I will calmly waltz away with $20 million of cash. You join me and share the spoils. Can you dig it?
I can dig it.
But there was one thing they didn't plan on.
Hell has come out of hiding.
Once upon a time in Mexico.
Oh, yeah. It might get a wee bit dangerous there, Sugar, but...
Rated R. Opens everywhere Friday.
It passes better than a West Coast offense. The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul.
Goodyear and its fleet of airships offering all kinds of pretty pictures tonight, reminding us to take all of life's journeys on the wings of Goodyear. Yeah. Mr. Ian, one time, I had one of those memorable birthdays, and I walked out on the sun deck, and there was a blimp right there.
You're kidding.
It scared me to death.
She did that for all, just for you, right?
Uh-huh. I don't know, for her. Second down, 2. That's close. The mark is good. It's close to the 40, and it'll be a first down.
Again, there's Steve Sarkisian, quarterback coach, did such a great job with Carson Palmer last year and is continuing with Matt Leinart under the tutelage and mentorship as Mike Williams heads to the locker room holding his left arm. There's Norm Chow upstairs enjoying his time here in Southern California. What results?
This is Chauncey Washington, a 205-pound freshman out of Torrance. Showed a little juke to the right, came back to the left, and picked up 3 yards on that carry. Here are the numbers for Norm during his 27 years over at BYU. I mean, the quarterbacks he had over there, Robbie Bosco, who is the offensive coordinator for Gary Croton, was one of those quarterbacks. But they were something. I mean, I thought one of the most uproarious times, interesting times at BYU was when Jim McMahon was the quarterback over there. Leinart puts it in the air. It's intercepted. Or it should have been. I don't know if he came up with it or not. No, he did not. But certainly the BYU man was the only one who had a chance to catch it, and it was Levi Madariaga. Madariaga was up at Washington at one time. Came from Weezer, Idaho, but transferred, and see, he had it right in his hands.
Well, Dominic Byrd got away with a face mask. That's why Levi couldn't make that catch. He had fingers poking him in the eye.
Yeah, pretty clear, but the man wearing the striped shirt was blocked from the view by the player. All right, Bush goes wide. Empties the backfield for Southern California on 3rd down and 7. Leinart's pass is intercepted. Wide open field in front of the interceptor, Josh Brendan. But he lost his balance when he made the catch and couldn't get away. I thought for a minute he'd take it home.
Well, Brandon's one of those cat players. Right cat, left cat. He's really a strong safety. But he read the coverage. Number three is Brandon. He steps right in front of that pass intended for Kerry Colbert. And Matt Leinart suffers his first interception, which really should have been his second one, because Madriata had his hands on the last pass.
And so the Cougars now own the football just short of midfield. First down. Berry's in there at quarterback. Remember, they played 351 games since they were shut out by Arizona State in 1975. That pass was intended for Chris Hale and thrown over his head. There's the interceptor. Joshua Brendan.
He probably wasn't going to score, but he kind of stumbled a little bit after he made that catch. He got a few more yards out of that return, but boys, throw that ball out in the flat like that, that quarterback's worst nightmare is having to chase somebody from behind, and in my case, never ever catching him.
Second down and 10. Berry puts some sizzle on this pass. It's good to about the 45-yard line of USC. Moment here with Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, not good news for USC. Number one, Mike Williams has an injury to his left wrist. They've taken him in, and they're going to get a precautionary X-ray. Now, I just talked to Russ, the trainer, right now. He says he doesn't know until that X-ray comes back, but I know everyone at USC is collectively holding their breath. Mike Williams in the locker room, injury to the left wrist. Keith.
Thank you, Todd. Boy, that's really bad news. He is one of the great players at that position in the country. Berry goes all the way across the field and then goes down. And that's a sack. Tatupu is the man to put him on the ground. He went out straight across the field, looking and looking and looking, and there was no white shirt available.
Keith, let's go back and see if we can detect when Mike Williams was injured. This is his fifth catch of the night. It's a slant route. As he catches the ball, he's going to get hit by about five Cougars. And it could be that one of those, as he flexes that left hand, could have been that shot.
Matt Payne is in the punt then on fourth down and 12. Arbet waiting. Low kick, might have some room to run with this one. Now, ball's kicked away from him, and takes a great bounce to Payne. Matt's going to wind up with a big kick. That's 45 yards and no return, and the ball is inside the 10, marked down at the 7-yard line. Monday night, Warren Sapp, the Super Bowl champ Buccaneers against McNabb and the Eagles. Donovan back in shape and running hard. Al Michaels, John Madden, Lisa Guerrero in Philly for the rematch of last year's NFC Championship game. That'll be in 6 Pacific time on ABC.
And a pretty good game last Thursday night, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was all right.
Very entertaining.
I nodded off a little here and there, but it was all.
I think the Skins liked it.
Yeah, Steve needed one, didn't he? Gets his dauber up a little bit. From the 7. Ball is handed off to Herschel Dennis. They haven't run very well so far tonight. BYU is pretty well shut them down. Gain on that play of about 2 yards. Herschel Dennis is 190. All these running backs are in that 190 range. Then you get up to Lindale White, we've yet to see tonight. He bruised a knee in practice, but he's 225 pounds. Whitney Lewis is 225 pounds, so they've got a lot of thump.
Yeah, they call the youngsters the Bruise Brothers. That thump.
Second down and 8. Cougars show blitz.
And they come in and they point at Herschel Dennis, said he moved.
Penalty flag.
False start.
Penalty flag was laying right between his feet. I wonder. Valvoline halftime show. John Saunders and Terry Bowden in New York City with a lot of scores and highlights. A lot of very interesting things. A big surprise of the day to me was Wake Forest. I never in the world would have expected it. The biggest disappointment of the day was probably Washington State Notre Dame game, where the very, very good place kicker missed the field goal and missed an extra point. And missed a chance for the Cougars to have one of the big wins of the year. I don't know what the Irish are going to be like. Herschel Dennis brings that one out to about the 13-yard line.
Well, aside from one interception over here, Matt Leinart's had a pretty good day throwing the ball. 11 out of 18 so far, but a lot of short passes, and he's gone deep a couple of times. Of course, this pass here, that's a little misleading. That was a short slant route that started over here and then ended up way down there.
So it is third down now and long, third and eight. Pressure coming, Leinart looking around. He almost taken down in the end zone. There's a penalty flag. Yep, came out it. Of the referee's pocket.
That's going to be 2 points for the Cougars. Now he's going to ask to see if there is a receiver in the area. Croton is saying that's a safety.
As Gary wanting his 2 points. Remember, it's been 351 games since they've been shut out. Here's Dave Kataya.
Full rounding, offense.
That's a
play
safety.
Results in a safety.
2 points. That's the first points of the year scored against the Southern California Trojan.
And it was scored against their offense.
The offense, yeah. The defense still hasn't given a point.
No, they haven't.
Well, Pete's arguing the case, but the man in the white hat threw the flag, made the call, and that'll do it.
Looks like KC Bills.
Yep, KC Bills.
Another freshman.
So Matt Leinart gets dinged for a safety. It's 21-2.
Circuit City's the place to save on DirecTV. Stop by today and you'll get a three-room DirecTV system free after mail-in rebate. With DirecTV, you'll get more movies, sports, family programming, and more. And right now at Circuit City, when you buy any new DirecTV system and activate NFL Sunday Ticket and Total Choice Premier programming, you'll get 4 free months of Total Choice Premier with local channels. Circuit City, we're with you.
Leon, you sign a record contract in the offseason. You come in with great numbers, Hall of Fame caliber numbers. But since then, disappointment. Your numbers are down. Who's to blame?
Well, Chuck, in this situation, I first have to look at myself.
The great ones do.
Right. So since you and I both know that can't be it, I gotta blame the fans and the media. And after that, it's the linemen's fault, it's the coach's fault, the owner's fault, turf, referees, announcers. May even be your fault, Chuck.
Monterey Bay has one of the most unique marine faunas in the entire world. I think this BYU program is everything that you would want in a research or in an academic environment. There's a large emphasis on the student-teacher relationship at BYU and directed research with close interaction mentoring with some of the top minds in the field.
The Brigham Young University Student Mentoring Initiative. Education that really gets your feet wet.
With 2:51 to go in the first half, the BYU Cougars have advanced their string of without being shut out, 352. There are the other teams, and you see the Cougars have a huge lead over everybody else. After the safety, the Trojans have to kick it away, and they'll punt it, and Malone hits a beauty. Wow. Back to the 11-yard line. Here comes David Christensen, and he's out across the 25 to the 28. The entire Mountain West Conference, I don't think I've ever seen this before, Dan, is on the road this week. The entire conference, everybody is on the road.
Why?
I don't know why. That's the way it was scheduled. San Diego State at Ohio State, Colorado State at Cal, Wyoming at Oklahoma State, and on and on and on. Air Force at Northwestern and UNLV at Kansas were the only two members of the conference that were favored to win. But the entire Mountain West Conference traveling to play their games today. Matt Berry back. Throws behind the receiver. Penalty flag is thrown. Coach the tight end. Big Daniel is close to the first down marker, but let's see about the flag. ineligible receiver downfield. Urban Meyer's Utah team is at Texas A&M, that game tonight. Colorado State at Cal, that's kind of an interesting matchup. UCLA today over in Colorado. Colorado winning over Colorado State last week. Pretty hard to beat Sonny Luby. Back to back.
Yeah, that Cal team, though, surprising. Went into Kansas State and put on a pretty good show a couple weeks back.
Well, it's 17-7 Colorado State in the second quarter.
So. Well, like you said, Sonny Luby is tough to beat two in a row. Trying to pump up the Pac-10, Keith. Come on.
First down and 15. Matt Berry's got a little trouble in traffic, and he's planted at the 20.
Yeah, this front four is really living up to their reputation and getting after Matt Berry and John Beck. Berry getting up a little slow, got a little hitch in his get-along.
See, that's the fourth sack of Berry.
And anytime he's got to come off that first receiver, that front four is there.
Yep, Mike Patterson, he's in his face that time. Your alma mater won today, 31-23. That's pretty close against Nevada.
Yeah, Nevada's a pretty good team, Keith, you know that. You can see the sacks there for Berry, gone down three times, Beck went down once.
Are they gonna wear those uniforms when we go up there on the 20th? That is picked off, thrown right into the arms of Marcel Allman. Intended for Chris Hale. It was underthrown. And the interception will give USC the ball with a minute and a half to play in the first half. And they've got the ball at the 44-yard line.
You brought up the Ducks, Keith. Well, this is a duck of a pass by Matt Berry. Trying to throw it deep down the sideline to the speedster Chris Hale, and he knows that the ball just must have slipped out of his hand. Because with a guy like Hale, who's got great speed, you just want to let it go as far as you can. That ball was quacking all the way down the field to Allman.
So from the 44, opportunity for the Trojans. Let's see if they can catch it. Liner steps up, hit from behind, and hit in a hurry by Big John Denny, number 92. Washington, the last I heard, was winning big over Indiana, and the others are all playing tonight.
See, John Denny, number 92, fighting his way through a double team block by Fred Matua and Winston Justice. First sack of the season for John Denny.
At second down and 12, the clock is running. 50 seconds. Leinert wanted to go deep. Now he's going to run it. And he's going to take a pretty good lick down around the 34-yard line, close to a first down. Now let's see if he can get up and walk straight.
Yeah, he hit the ground pretty hard, and the Cougars hit him. Ball came loose, but it was after he was ruled to be down. That's a dangerous run going head first there at the end of that run by Matt Leinert. But he's got a lot of field open as he breaks this pocket. It's away from James Allen there, who was on a safety blitz. And the ball clearly was in his possession when his knee hit the ground. Remember, Mike Williams has got a still in the locker room having his left arm x-rayed.
It is a first down for the Trojans. At the 34-yard line, the clock had stopped at 41 seconds to play in the first half. 21-2, your score, Southern California. They had a big first quarter, been kind of quiet since. The interception here has given them the ball. They've scored twice off turnovers. This would be the third time if they get something out of it. Leinert lets it go for the end zone, and it's just over the head of Kerry Colbert.
And a ball sailed behind Colbert. Leinert's got to get that ball out in front. Look, Colbert was on a deep post route, and the ball sailed on Leinert, much as it did on Matt Berry. Fortunate for Leinert, the ball carried out of the back of the end zone.
Chad Barney was running with Colbert. Pretty good coverage on him.
Yeah, he did. But the ball has got to be thrown over here. see how Colbert has to adjust his route to try to chase that ball down.
Second down and 10 at the 34. Time remaining 25 plus, 25.3 if you wish to have the exact digital count.
Pressure, got him.
Outside the 40. And that's probably going to do it. Oh, the whistle stopping. Dave Kutaya comes in, the referee, and whistled it dead. And a timeout call by a USC with right about 18 seconds remaining.
The Pac-10 Education Initiative is a focused effort to assist teachers in improving elementary and middle school test scores. At the heart of the initiative is a learning program called Kids College, and it uses Pac-10 sports activities for boys and girls to teach math and language skills. Kids College makes learning fun. Log on now to learn more. The Pac-10, the Conference of Champions.
We're now in the cool, cool, cool of the evening after a hot day in Southern California, and very pleasant for the football players now, though it was quite warm when they started. Just over 17 seconds remaining to play in the first half. And Southern California calling the timeout with a third and 16 coming up. They want to get it down close enough, I would think, so that Colleen would have a shot at it.
It's very apparent that SC's passing game isn't quite the same without Mike Williams in the game. Leinert's searching for a reliable favorite receiver right now.
And his go-to guy's gone. Mike Williams. Pressure's coming. Ball's popped up in the air. It's intercepted. And BYU has it. It is John Denny, who's had about a real hot 3.5 minutes here. John making play after play after play. And he comes up with an interception on the ricochet. And you've got just over 8 seconds remaining in the first half. So BYU will get one more play.
That's a pretty good play by John Denny. Here he is right out here. Watch after the ball is knocked up into the air. The center, Norm Katnick, and he are going to go for the ball, and he just pulls it away from Katnick for the interception. We've seen his first sack of the year moments ago, and now John Denny gets his first career interception.
So the Trojans now, they go 21-0 first quarter. They've done very little in the second quarter. The offense gave up a safety for BYU's only points. That's Matt Leinert. Now that's what he looks like when he takes off that hard hat. He's a good-looking guy.
And remember, SC did call a timeout, so BYU's got a chance for a field goal here. Matt Payne's got a great leg. He's got a career long of 52 yards. So they need to pick up about 10 yards on this to give him a shot at a long field goal.
Ball is thrown down the middle, and it'll go to about the 36-yard line in the arms of Daniel Coates. And you've got 3.8 seconds.
So that means a 53, maybe 54-yard field goal now for Matt Payne.
The big fella from North Ogden. His career long is 52 against New Mexico. Last week against Georgia Tech, he made 24, missed 28.
And he is a big fella. 6'4", 234, so you know he's got power.
Here's Todd for a moment.
Well, Keith, it's a paying thing at BYU. Matt Perry is the kicker now. He's got another year. They've already recruited his younger brother, Mitch Payne, from Weber High School. And believe it or not, there's another Payne, Mason Payne. He happens to play on my young son Alex's soccer team today, and I want to let you know that the Sidekicks won their opener today 4-0. So the Payne kids know how to kick.
You're bragging.
That report was a pain.
This is a 53-yarder. It'll be the longest of his career if he makes it. Wind is not a factor. If anything, it would help him, but I don't think there's enough tonight. On the way. Got it. 53 yards. And BYU makes it a 5-point total in the first half. USC 21 and BYU 5 as Matt Payne kicks a 53-yard field goal.
And he had plenty of leg on that one. That ball might have gone from 60 yards.
Yeah, I think so. Here's Todd.
Well, he's a defensive coordinator. Those kind of things make you miserable. You stress defense all week and turnovers. You got it to start out, and then you gave back too.
Yeah, real disappointed that we got sloppy like that. Gave them, we didn't have to give them a darn thing, but we did. So we got to come back. They'll be a real good football team in the second half. We need to be better.
All right, good luck, Coach.
All right.
All right. That's where we are at halftime. Now let's catch up on the rest of the day with John and Terry at Times Square Stadium.
Keith, thanks a lot. And Pete Carroll, boy, he could be tough on his team, up 21-5 at halftime, and he's disappointed with what he saw in the first half.
Well, that's a defensive coach. He didn't want him scoring ever, and it's this defense that I'm so impressed with. Last week, great against the rush, but they're great against the pass. Sometimes your best pass defense, though, are your sacks. They're killing this quarterback. They've got two sacks already. They've got him scrambling all over the field.
And they better hope that they stay at five, or they're going to be running extra sprints after the game. The marquee matchup of the day, Florida against Miami. And the Canes, they won 22 straight at home. Devin Hester, how jacked up were they? This is the opening kickoff, Terry. 97 yards for a touchdown.
Well, it looked like it was going to be a rout. They just went in by everybody, and it looked like Miami was going to just run Florida off the field. But, John, it's been Florida since then. Florida taking the battle to Miami.
Some mistakes for Miami as well. Brock Berlin, this is a lateral. Well, that's easy to pick it up and run it in. Keewon Ratliff does that.
Well, it was the Florida quarterbacks that were supposed to be so nervous, but Brock Berlin's getting knocked around a couple of sacks, and he throws a poor judgment lateral right there that goes for a touchdown.
Ingle Martin has a touchdown pass. He's 5 of 8 for 71 yards, but the Canes right now are down 16-10. And as you mentioned, this doesn't look like a team that lost one game, or two games rather, over the last three seasons combined.
Well, John, I've always said they have as much talent on this team as last year, but they are not as experienced, and experience wins championship. Not experienced at quarterback, not experienced at running back, and they don't have the experience at wide receiver.
And you can bet that the Florida Gators right now, Brock Berlin, the last time he started a game before this year, was for them in the Orange Bowl. USC has reason to cheer about as well.
Woo! 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 Holding
zone.
Number one, baby. Number one.
I win.
The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul.
In 1969, the legend of Gatorade embarked on an historic journey from the swamp of Gainesville to the battle-hardened turf of the NFL. The baby back ribs weren't the only thing getting basted in the heat of Kansas City.
E.J. Hollop, the toughest guy on the team, kept running out of gas.
It was hotter than a Texas tamale.
Salvation came in the ring of the phone.
Ray Graves called me. He was a good friend.
Ray Graves of the Florida Gators said his players were drinking this stuff called Gatorade.
That Gatorade really did the job. It was like liquid gold.
Come on, Lenny! Against the heavily favored Vikings in Super Bowl IV, the Chiefs emerged victorious. And the rest is history.
There's no better way to rehydrate athletes.
And today, Gatorade is on every sideline, every down, every game.
From boys to men, from one generation to the next, the games never end. And the legend continues.
Let's say this is you.
Yeah, you're the king.
But being the king isn't always easy. So, when you're with Allstate, you'll have over 50,000 professionals to help protect you. From claims adjusters who can help you fix a broken castle, to emergency assistants to ride your rescue, to lawyers that go to court with you if you need them, and your Allstate agent who knows the moves to help you. Helping you, the king, feel protected. Just one more way you're in good hands with Allstate.
Dear DirecTV, since 1995, I've had NFL Sunday Ticket. I haven't missed one second of any Colts game since. My wife has a horse. Its name, Peyton. Of course. Sincerely, Jimmy Jablonski.
Yeah. They sent a photo. I think we found our DirecTV mascot.
NFL Sunday Ticket, more games than anywhere else, only from DirecTV. Sign up now and get our best programming package free for 4 months.
Wardrobe.
Valvoline Halftime Show. Brought to you by Valvoline's Max Life, who reminds you at 75,000 miles, it's time to switch to Max Life. From Times Square, New York, John Saunders and Terry Bowden.
USC with a 21-5 lead over BYU as we head towards the second half. But first, let's continue with scores and highlights. The number one team in the nation, Oklahoma, playing at Tuscaloosa, Alabama. First time, surprisingly, that a number one team has had to play at Alabama in Tuscaloosa. Of course, they played all their big games in Birmingham, so it doesn't matter. Jason White remembers this game for a year ago and knocked him out. Mark Bradley takes this one deep, and it sets it up again. Jason White looking for Mark Clayton. Not the former Dolphin, but the current Sooner. Touchdown.
Well, that's the way you set things up. You run the same play twice, hit a different guy. Hit the short guy one time, hit the long guy. It's the very same play.
13-3 is the lead right now. As you see, White, 9 of 18 for 113 yards. He's just happy to still be in the game after what happened last year. Kansas State, well, they tried to fool us at the start of the season by playing Cal. But now they get back to this soft schedule that they usually play at the start. 38-14 over McNeese State.
There ought to be some kind of punishment for playing this off-conference schedule they've got. Really a ho-hum day, but Kansas State's not worried too much about McNeese State.
Darren Sproles, remember, was hurt last week, so it's good to see him in there. Has over 100 yards. Maryland against Florida State. Chief Osceola ready to go. As the Florida State Seminoles look to pick up their second consecutive win in conference early in the season. Greg Jones, I think there's something wrong with his knee. What do you think?
I don't know, but he got the ball in the wrong hands. He put it on the outside. I'd have benched him if he did that if I was coaching. That's why I'm not coaching anymore. I'd have benched him.
Your coaches are so critical. 21-10, Florida State has the lead. This is a year kind of one of redemption for your father, because he's coming off a couple of seasons that most programs would have loved to have, 8 wins, 9 wins, but anybody but Florida State would love those statistics.
And I think he likes what he sees, because Chris Ricks throws an interception for a touchdown on the very first play of the game. Last year, I probably would have tanked it. This year, he comes back, had a strong performance from that play on. That's what they need to see.
He knows Adrian McPherson is not behind him right now, waiting to get into that uniform. Kent State against Pittsburgh. Now, Rod Rutherford, the quarterback for Pittsburgh, suspended somewhat. They said he had to sit out a few plays.
One play.
He's got 4 touchdown passes in the game. Had a little altercation outside of a nightclub. Pittsburgh's going to win easily.
They are going to win easily. I love it when that coach says he's going to suspend him for one play.
Like Jim Valvano once said to me, he says, as long as your best player's on the bus, then you can leave. The rest of the guys, they can stick around. We'll continue with more of the Valvoline Halftime Show in a moment from here in Times Square. USC having their way with BYU.
What do you think? It's perfect. That's exactly what I want.
What?
Except bigger.
What do you mean bigger?
Something really pops the eye. Maybe rubies alternating with the sapphires. More stones. Pave diamonds all the way around.
Life's little expenses. Another good reason to keep your car around. That's why at 75,000 miles, switch to Valvoline's Max Life. Its added ingredients help prevent wear on critical parts.
Hey, this is nothing, guys. For the honeymoon?
Oh. At 75,000, time to switch to Max Life.
If you don't use fuel to clear your head, if you've never had a Sunday ride extend through Tuesday, if the only thing that wanders is your mind, get out of the way. The all-new Suzuki SV1000S.
Who's going to invent the next internet? Who'll create the new museums, new treaties, new countries? Who'll create the new wealth? Who'll make art as everyday as coffee shops? And who'll make age irrelevant? Who'll make bridges that feel like music? We don't know their names yet, but we see them every day. USC, University of the 21st Century.
Pacific 10 Conference, the Conference of Champions.
Night has fallen on Times Square as we continue with the Valvoline Halftime Show. John Saunders alongside of Terry Bowden. You coaches always talk about this. You can't get enough deep depth, which always seemed redundant to me. Well, they have that at Virginia Tech at quarterback. Of course, Marcus Vick not playing today because of a suspension, so Brian Randle would have to handle the entire duties. But this is the problem for Frank Beamer's team. Kevin Jones out of bounds, right? He lets up and overcomes Demetrius Chamblain and just shoves him. The flags come all over the place, but that doesn't help because Jones has to leave the game. He did not return. Cedric Humes, 11 yards out. They still win easily.
I'll tell you, if my Heisman candidate, Kevin Jones, cannot come back in that game, is hurt for the year, I'll never play James Madison again.
Get him off the schedule. San Diego State, Ohio State. Ohio State struggled in this game. Matt Dogalecki, that's the backup quarterback for San Diego State. He had a touchdown pass. He's picked off by Will Allen. Takes it 100 yards.
I'm glad he did take it 100 yards, too, because Ohio State's offense never showed up. They were flat. They didn't come to play. Never scored an offensive touchdown. Doesn't look like a national championship team to me.
They have NC State next week on ABC. They should be glad they weren't facing the Wolverines today. Chris Perry, over 200 yards a week ago, close to 200 yards again.
I said the Heisman Trophy was going to be won by a Wolverine, not John DeBar. Chris Perry, that is.
Georgia against Middle Tennessee State. It was a bit of a struggle to Michael Cooper. 4 yards in this touchdown run. A couple of late. Green had a good day, and they get the win. And Marshall in Tennessee. Marshall, very good offensively, and they gave fits to Casey Clawson as well. 27 yards here to Tony Brown, though, as Tennessee grabs a 14-10 lead. And then Clawson to Troy Fleming as they put the game away late. Cedric Houston had 160 yards on the ground.
Well, Tennessee had to have a good game. This is a much better Marshall team than people realize. Casey Clawson has a good game.
It could be a long year for Tyrone Willingham. He has an amazing schedule. And it looked like he was going to stumble out of the gate. They trailed this entire game, but Julius Jones, back on the team after academic problems a year ago, goes 19 yards and the touchdown, and Notre Dame has the lead. But late, under a minute remaining, Matt Kegel goes 27 yards to Sammy Moore, and with the extra point, the game is tied at 26 and headed to overtime. Nick Setta. This would be his fifth field goal of the game. He bangs it through. He had five against Maryland a year ago in the opener and a victory. And the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, we have talked about this. Tyrone Willingham, terrific coach, did a great job last year. But the last two games of the season, they struggled. And with this schedule, it could have been a struggle. They could not afford to lose this game at home.
No way. And they looked a lot like last year at the beginning. They played great defense, but they couldn't do a thing on offense. Then Julius Jones comes in, excites the offense. Ryan Grant, Julius Jones, they now have an outstanding running attack. It may turn that offense around.
But Nick Setta, a good field goal kicker like that can change a lot of fortunes for you coaches.
Yeah, but if you kick field goals every time you get the ball, you're not going to win a national championship, I promise you.
You better kick five every time you get the ball as well. We will continue from New York City in a moment. This is the Valvoline Halftime Show.
Little expenses. Another good reason to keep your car around. That's why at 75,000 miles, switch to Valvoline's Max Life. Its added ingredients help prevent wear on critical parts.
Hello, gorgeous girl.
At 75,000, time to switch to Max Life.
We're back. Player's still down on the field. How do you deal with that as a coach?
Well, you know, when a player gets hurt and you're a coach, it doesn't make a difference if your player or it's the other team's player. Everything stops until you're sure he's okay.
And he's up.
It looks like he's gonna be all right.
Outback's curbside takeaway. Call up, pull up, then enjoy the great taste of Outback anywhere.
The Valvoline Halftime Show, brought to you by Valvoline's Max Life, who reminds you at 75,000 miles, it's time to switch to Max Life.
George Lopez with Sandra Bullock to tell you that this fall, my show's moving to Friday nights at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
El Super Jorge Lopez se mueve a viernes a las 8, 7 Central en ABC.
Sandy, you could be a soccer announcer.
George Lopez, Friday, September 26th, part of the all-new TGIF on ABC.
This is the man.
Senior Deputy John Henry Barnes.
Who will train the guy.
My first day on the job.
Who was once a thug.
Remember how close you came to going to jail?
And now wears the badge.
I don't even want to like you. My job is to train you.
Well, I like you, sir.
Shut up.
10 8. Officers on duty, ABC Sunday, September 28th.
A reminder, next Saturday on ABC, we start at noon. Some of you will see NC State coming off the loss against Ohio State, who survived a scare. Others get Arkansas against Texas. That is at noon. Then at 3:30, a national game. The Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, big win today against Washington State. They will face unbeaten Michigan. And in primetime at 8, some will see Penn State battle Nebraska. Others will get Georgia Tech and Florida State. While others yet will get Illinois and UCLA in the Rose Bowl. Check local listings for the game in your area. Earlier today, some upsets, if you will, perhaps not, for Wake Forest mascot. He watches as Cornelius Burgs goes 16 yards on a touchdown run.
This is such a tough offense to stop. They run the option. They great fakes, misdirection. Tough to stop that offense.
Virginia and South Carolina. Dondrell Pinkins, 6-yard touchdown run. You're watching Bulls weigh in.
Well, I'll tell you, this is a perfect Lou Holtz game. They had a bad game last week, but barely won. He comes back, gets the big upset.
Auburn and Georgia Tech. Auburn hoping not to go 0-2. Reggie Ball, the freshman, had a terrific game.
I'll tell you, Chan Gailey, he lost so many players in the offseason. Reggie Ball, a sensational true freshman quarterback.
And Boston College, a difficult loss in week number one, but today against Penn State, Quinton Porter, 37 yards to Tony Gonzalez.
Well, he had to replace Brian St. Pierre, who's now in the NFL. You didn't know what kind of quarterback he was. They look like they loaded with another one.
Purdue, ranked number 20, also a loser today to Bowling Green, 27-26. But at the start of it, I said, right, upsets perhaps, not really.
No, there's so much parity. I didn't look at one of these games as being an upset. It looked like to me in every game that the best team won.
And it's difficult for you coaches to convince your players that even though anyone can win any game, that they're going to lose one.
They read the paper clippings. They hear the stands. They believe what people tell about them the entire offseason.
They also look ahead perhaps and see who else is down the road in the schedule. We'll continue with scores and highlights. Right now, let's take it back out to your game.
The Trojan. Southern California is leading Brigham Young University 21-5 at halftime. ABC Sports presentation of college football back after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
What do people see in the new Chrysler Pacifica?
I see a woman who knows how to relax.
I see a man who knows where he's going in the world.
I see a painter, a parent, an individual.
I see a mom and a dad who are completely behind their kids.
Introducing the Chrysler Pacifica, well beyond the SUV.
Your British sailor, circa 1740, knew that citrus fruit could prevent scurvy. Now, that's got to be the only conceivable reason a man would put a lime in his beer. Then again, how bad can scurvy be? A certain amount of risk goes hand in hand with living. The high life.
You never saw what was coming.
Hello.
And you never imagined.
What's this about bringing a hooker to a client's wedding?
The invitation said significant other.
Just how different the practice could be.
I feel icky.
James Spader joins the most risk-taking show on television. The Practice, season premieres Sunday, September 28th on ABC.
Attention! Cable rates have increased up to 5 times the rate of inflation in 1 year. At Dish Network, you get the best technology at the home of the lowest all-digital price every day. Visit Radio Shack Sears or a local participating retailer or call 1-800-WOW-DISH.
I'm not a mechanic, but I've seen motors apart. They're unbelievable. I saw the carbon crud buildup on the valves. You see, now I never knew that was from a lot of gasolines, to be honest with you. But, you know, it makes sense. So, I guess Techron's a good thing, you know? Right?
Help keep vital engine parts clean. Chevron with Techron.
I really don't know what's up with that part.
I think the best of local television is what you do because you know your community. And you have that wonderful advantage of driving to work, walking to work through the very community you're going to go and report on. I think that's fabulous. You walk down any street in any town in America and you'll fall over a story. There's nothing more exciting for any of us than being excited. Did you know what I saw yesterday? And I think that is one of the sort of essences of journalism, seeing something, interpreting it, analyzing it, and then telling other people.
Outsmart your cable company and switch to Dish Network Satellite TV. Entertainment packages start as low as $24.99 a month. Call now and get a three-room system free with free installation. Visit Radio Shack Sears or a local participating retailer or call 1-800-WOW-DISH.
Thanks for watching K2.
The spirit of the Northwest.
Well, Big Mike Williams has come out of the locker room. X-rays negative on his wrist, and he is cleared to play in the second half. The Trojans leading 21-5, and the numbers look like this.
Well, the sloppy play in that first half, a muff punt there by David Christensen led to an SC touchdown, and then Omar Nazel takes that interception back 16 yards. Now the intentional grounding, which turned into a safety, Casey Wills with that big play. And how about John Denny picking up this interception that led to Matt Payne's 53-yard field goal, second longest in BYU history, but longest ever at sea level.
And the first points allowed by the USC defense at field goal.
Yeah, the 5 points, you know, it doesn't seem like much, but remember, that's a 16-point difference. That's two scores and two extra points.
They're hanging around.
Yes, they are. They are playing a lot better at the end of that first half than SC did. SC, as Pete Carroll said, got real sloppy.
And the second and third weeks of every football season are weeks for upsets. And we've had some today, and we're going to have some next week, I bet you.
Well, we might even have one tonight. Let's take a look at our first half Pacific Life game summary. And, it's, of course, the big story being the turnovers. But if you look at the rushing yardage, you can see both teams are doing horribly there. But you got to factor in the sack yardage. Minus 27 yards in sack yards for BYU and 13 yards for USC, a negative there. So both teams need to work on that running game. We'll see if SC can get something going. Big plus for them having Mike Williams back in the lineup.
The kickoff goes to the Trojans to start the second half of play. The return is over the 25 to the 30 by Reggie Bush. And a moment ago, Todd Harris had this brief conversation with Cougar coach Gary Croton.
Coach, you take away two bad turnovers. It could be 7-5. We give a baseball score here.
We're playing pretty good on defense. We let him get that slant, but I think we've done a good job since then. And he scored that. We got that big play. But we let him get out of down and distance problems, and then we get ourselves into down and distance problems. We got to do a better job on that on both sides of the ball.
You feel like you've smacked him in the mouth yet?
They know we're a good football team. I know that. But right now, we got to play good on offense and continue to play good on defense.
Good luck, Coach. Thanks.
All right, a personal foul now has moved the football up to midfield, the personal foul against BYU, and now here are the Trojans in the catbird seat, leading 21-5 to start the third quarter from the 50-yard line. Matt Leinart stays in there at quarterback, obviously. The left-hander puts it up quickly on a little pop to Colbert, and it's too low, and Curry can't come up with it, and it's second down and 10. USC is yet to run the ball with any efficiency or authority.
Kennedy Poehler, their running backs coach, said the way they rotate their running backs, at least early in the season so far, is they want to be play specific. So when Herschel Dennis is in the game, they'll run more between the tackles. Reggie Bush wants to get to the outside and cut back. So we'll see play specific calls called for different players.
Mike Williams is down on the near side. They go the other way. The ball is slapped at the line of scrimmage and drops incomplete.
Take a look at our Chrysler passing playbook. You wonder, is SC stealing a page out of the BYU playbook? This pass play to Mike Williams is very similar to what we've seen the Cougars doing tonight. A very spread offense. This is back in the first half. But didn't Norm Chow write the book on passing and especially the spread offense?
If he didn't, he edited it. Williams again on the near side, single coverage on him, and Leinart again hit very hard as he delivers the ball. I mean, he was smacked right in the chops and went down hard.
Yeah, and that's what Gary Croton's talking about. He wants SC to know that they're in for a fight, and the momentum is on BYU's side right now. The blitz there, a good clean hit there by John Denny. Nothing illegal about that at all, and it sends a big message, not only to Leinart, but to Norm Chow and this SC offense.
And they force the Trojans to punt. After opening the series at midfield, Malone is in to do the kicking, and it's a beauty. Into the end zone. They come out to the 20 for the Cougars, where they'll have it first down. The sun is just beyond the stadium now. There's no sun inside the stadium to speak of, the Coliseum, if you will, and will be gone into the Pacific waters very soon.
That was a big stop for the BYU defense. Remember, they got the personal foul call penalty on the kickoff, and so SC had great field position to start that drive, but could manage just three plays and then out.
Matt Perry and quarterback.
You got three wide, and the deep man is Brathwaite. Perry turns, and Barry gives the ball to Brathwaite, and he'll get it out for about 7-8 yards. Udazi, the tackle for the Trojans. The front four has held up very well for USC in this ball game. I think this front four will hold up against most anybody.
Yeah, they've stuffed the run completely and got great pressure on Matt Barry, and when John Beck was in the game, they've sacked SC quarterbacks four times.
Ball is thrown very hard and completed to the tight end Daniel Coates, and Coates is going to have a first down for BYU. Grootegood on the tackle for Southern California.
Key to a good pass play is pass protection. It all starts up front for Matt Barry and the Cougars. Good pocket. There you can see number 20, big Daniel Coates going across the middle. Perfect strike by Barry, or Matt Leach picks that off and dances into the end zone.
From the 31, first down. Brathwaite running in the middle of the field. Running very well for 12 yards and another first down. So all of a sudden, they're finding a little daylight. They're opening up the middle of that front four, and maybe they're catching them slanting.
Yeah, this is a big offensive line, Keith. Right guard, Jake Carreza, number 73, right here with a key block on Tatupa. Carreza goes 358 pounds.
Barry's pass complete to Christensen. He's got some daylight. And finally, run out of bounds by Will Poole.
Well, BYU now has SC's full attention because they're winning this ball game. Not on the scoreboard, but the attitude. This is exactly what Gary Croton told me yesterday, wanted to see happen.
Gain of 26 yards.
There's got to be a point in this game where they feel like, bam, we're standing up to them. And when that, and I think it has to happen fairly early. Once that happens, if it does, and which I'm okay on, when that happens, then we're going to be in a good football game.
26 yards on that play. First down is at the 31-yard line. Barry swings it out. This time, the Trojans get a clean tackle in the open field on Vakapuna. Marcel Aumann making the hit.
And it was a surprising thing for BYU is that they're leading receiver Toby Christensen has been held without a catch so far. So look for Barry to start looking up number 80. He did have a drop earlier in the game. Toby Christensen is a key veteran receiver and the son of NFL great Todd Christensen, who played with the Raiders and college at BYU.
Second down and six. Barry gets his pass away, and that is incomplete, out of bounds. The man tormenting him on that particular play was number 52, Lawan Ramsey, a sophomore out of Compton. There's a lot of youth on both these teams.
Yeah, and Ramsey is a defensive tackle who can play a defensive end as well. Had a big game last week in very limited playing time against Auburn. He won sack, he forced a fumble, and that time pressured Barry into that incompletion on second down.
Third down and six. Ball is at the 28-yard line. Blitz coming. Pick it up. Throw it in the middle. Good. First down, BYU. Coach made the catch. Aumann was the man blitzing.
Ahman came off his corner position, and Barry actually misread the play. The wide receiver on that side was wide open, and Ahman comes. Here's Marcel Ahman, and the wide receiver looks like hail out here. Barry should have thrown him the ball, but Barry is looking at big number 20 right over the middle. He's wide open as well.
Brathwaite threw a block to give Barry time to make that play. Ball is on the 14-yard line of USC. The drive goes down the middle of the field mostly, and that pass is thrown hard and misses as Kukuhiko could not reel it in.
Watch the hit on Jason Kukuhiko there. The ball thrown out in front, and Jason Leach from his weak safety spot punishes the receiver. But SC, this is new territory for them to be backed up. First time an opponent's been inside the red zone in a game and a half.
Second and 10. Barry looks for Coach, throws. He's got it. Touchdown. Darnell Bing, the freshman safety, covering the tight end Coates, and Coates won the skirmish.
He had six catches last week against Georgia Tech, six already tonight, and the quarterback, Matt Barry, you could have said he forced that ball in there between three Trojans, but when you got hands like that, confidence in your receiver, the payoff's another touchdown.
Kick is good, and the Cougars are hanging around.
They're doing better than that, Keith. That's 12 unanswered points for the BYU.
11:51 to play in the third quarter. It's 21-12 now.
For our lowest rate on a great car, go thrifty.com.
What do people see in the new Chrysler Pacifica?
I see a woman who knows how to relax.
I see a man who knows where he's going in the world.
I see a painter, a parent, an individual.
I see a mom and a dad who are completely behind their kids.
Introducing the Chrysler Pacifica, well beyond the SUV.
It still says transmission complete, but that's not true because the paper won't go into the machine. It's not
hey,
being
Walt,
fed.
FedEx delivery
just
for you.
Just toss it on my desk.
You got it.
Yes, I'm pressing receipt now. Pressing receipt, nothing's happening. It's flashing A7. No, I do not know what that means. If I knew what it meant, do you think I'd be calling you right now?
FedEx Freight.
Owner's manual.
Now along with Express and Ground. Fast, reliable service with a money-back guarantee. Relax, it's FedEx.
For our lowest rate on a great car, go thrifty.com.
Room service. Your grape nuts, sir.
It'd take four bowls of grape nuts to get the B vitamins in just one bowl of total.
That's a manly breakfast. Your raisin bran.
10 bowls to equal the zinc in total.
I'll keep the gym open. Your special K, Ms.
40 bowls to equal the calcium in total.
Late checkout this morning?
You need Total. It's got 100% daily value of 12 vitamins and minerals. No other leading cereal comes close.
Pull a total,
I'll take Total.
Kitchen's just closed.
Total, Total Raisin Bran. One bowl, 100%.
Tough, rough, in your face. You won't believe what he does next. Blue's stunning season opener, ABC Tuesday, September 23rd, 10, 9 Central.
Yeah.
A brief look at the setting sun. You've got Los Angeles, you've got Beverly Hills, Santa Monica, and down it goes into the Pacific. Another day is about done. BYU has scored the first touchdown of the season against the USC defense. They're very much in the ball game now. It's 21-12. The ball is kicked off the field of play. It'll come out to the 20.
Take a look at this last touchdown, Keith. Watch the quarterback, Matt Barry. He is going to be looking for number 20 in white against number 20 in red. just squeezes it between Darnell Bing, number 20, and Melvin Simmons, number 20, or 51. That's three touchdown catches for Daniel Coates on the year, and four touchdown passes by Matt Berry. What a great throw.
And from the 20 now, let's see whether or not USC can answer. Liner throws to Williams. Mike Williams. See why he's tough to handle. He's very quick and agile at 6'5", 230, and he's going to pick up about 7 yards on that play.
He really has the total package, the size and the quickness, the speed, and the upper body strength. You can see he's got his left wrist heavily taped. Went in to get x-rays. Working on the outside here against Chad Barney. Nice move there. Now the upper body strength leaning forward and getting an extra yard.
Put him on the 28th. Needs two for the first down. Second down. Leinert throws. Ball's batted around. Intercepted. Knocked up in the air. And BYU catches it on the way down. It's Freddy Popinga. Made the catch. And BYU gets a Trojan turnover. Looked like Josh Brendan was the man that knocked the ball up in the air.
It sure was, Keith. Got up in the air, and now it's live. Heads up by Popinga to find where that ball was, but that's two big plays tonight for Josh Brendan.
And BYU is in business at USC 28, and now all of a sudden, the Trojans are feeling some heat.
Yeah, and the Cougars are walking on air.
Double wide, top of the screen. Berry hands the ball away to Vakapuna, and Tatupu takes care of him.
Very good.
Owongalema.
Lofa Tatupu with the tackle. And keep. That's what you need out of your middle linebacker. You need somebody to change the momentum. Vakapuna looked like he might have had something off that left side, but that hole was closed quickly by Lofa.
And it's second down and 11. Ball on the 29 now. Barry working out of the shotgun. Oh, boy. No time on that one. Three of them there. Mike Patterson, Kenichi Udeze are the principals on the sack of the quarterback.
Well, after the turnover, SC's defense has responded back-to-back plays. First the play by Tatupu, and now the pressure of this front four with the blitz coming. There's no place for Barry to go except to step back into Kenichi Udeze, number 94.
Who once weighed 355 pounds. He's a horse now. Penalty flag. Barry's throw complete. Goes to Toby Christensen. He gains it, carries it down to the 24-yard line, but your flag is back up around the 43. 40, I'm sorry, 38. And it's against BYU. So while they mark it off, let's spend a moment with John for an update.
Well, there's some surprise happening at the Orange Bowl in this Taco Bell update. Deshaun Wayne, you see the overloading of the left side. They just hand it off, send it the other way, and a couple of terrible missed tackles by the Canes. It covers 65 yards in Florida, opening up a lead. Remember, Miami's won 22 straight at home, but they're down by 16.
Well, now. A new era may be cooking down in Gainesville, huh? Miami's last regular season loss was a game we did up in Seattle in 2000 where the Huskies beat them. Third down now and 23 at the 41-yard line. Barry turns, hands the ball away, and whistles had stopped it before they got it cranked up.
Again, BYU having all types of trouble with their offense.
Burned the clock that time.
Yeah, that's inexcusable. Illegal procedure, illegal shifting. Now Yeah, at the sack end, they had field position at the 28-yard line. Boys, you're heading in the wrong direction. See the problems they had last week against Georgia Tech with penalties.
Yeah, they had 14 in that ball game.
So it's third down and 28 now after that 5-yard mock off. And Barry looking around, doing his shopping among his receivers, and finally throws it back into the middle of the field to David Christensen. And David will get down around the 37. And we're going to bring up a fourth and 19. And here's Mr. Payne, who has kicked a 53-yarder tonight, longest of his career. And the second longest ever at BYU. And let's see where they put this one down. This one would be 54. Well, Matthew, have at it. Yeah, hooked it. Hooked it left and missed it. Made from 53 and missed from 54. 8:01 to go in the third quarter. It's a 21-12, 9-point lead for Southern California.
In 1868, an American tradition was beginning, and Pacific Life was founded, both built on principles of persistence, performance, and strength. 135 years later, those beliefs still guide Pacific Life. It's how we help so many businesses and individuals reach their financial goals. For insurance, annuities, and investments, rely on the strength of Pacific Life, proud sponsor of the Pacific Life Holiday Bowl.
Circuit City's the place to save on DirecTV. Stop by today and you'll get a three-room DirecTV system free after mail-in rebate. With DirecTV, you'll get more movies, sports, family programming, and more. And right now at Circuit City, when you buy any new DirecTV system and activate NFL Sunday Ticket and Total Choice Premier programming, you'll get 4 free months of Total Choice Premier with local channels. Circuit City, we're with you.
What do people see in the new Chrysler Pacifica?
I see a woman who knows how to relax.
I see a man who knows where he's going in the world.
I see a painter, a parent, an individual.
I see a mom and a dad who are completely behind their kids.
Introducing the Chrysler Pacifica, well beyond the SUV.
Time permitting, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report featuring scores and highlights from across the country. Matt Leinart started out, Trojan started out, big, 21-0. Leinart was 11 of 16, 131 yards and 2 touchdowns. And then they ground to a halt. He's been one of the last 9 passes for 8 yards and three interceptions, two of them recorded.
He's been bounced around a lot, too.
Yep.
And right now, it's just clear that the defensive line is just out-quicking that SC offensive line. Our Pacific Life game summary, let's take a look at how BYU has gotten back into this game. Casey Wills with the sack, forcing the penalty there for the safety. And John Denny's interception will lead to Matt Payne's 53-yard field goal. That made it 5 points in a row. And now this 14-yard strike from Barry to Daniel Coates, 21-12 SC, but 12 straight points for the Cougs.
It's second down and 10 on the 37-yard line for USC. They go to an I. The deep back is Reggie Bush. And Bush turns it up inside and gets it over the 40 to the 41 before Mike Tanner takes his feet away.
And Mike Tanner is the middle linebacker. And in talking to Bronco Mendenhall about the important people in this defense, he says you got to be strong up the middle. Our middle guard, Daniel Marquardt, is a tough guy, can control both gaps on the center. Tanner's the emotional leader of this BYU defense, and then the Cougar position, Aaron Francisco, plays the middle linebacker spot, basically, but a little bit deeper.
Pitch it to Bush, going to the right side, and that's a first down.
Well, he's close to fumbling that ball.
Yeah. Man was running toward him, pointing his finger, and where he's pointing is not going to be a first down.
Boy, Bush was close, though, to breaking it, though, wasn't he?
Yes, he was.
He knows it too. He's looking up at the replay board, seeing just who got a finger on him there.
They'll measure this one.
Carrying the ball loosely. His knee is down. Ball comes out late. Good call by the officials.
Short. Just a tad. Fourth down and 6 inches.
This is a decision time for Pete Carroll. Looked like he said, let's go for it. With a quarterback like Matt Leinart, 6'5", 220, you only need an inch or two. Quarterback sneak's not a bad call, especially with the quickness of this BYU defense. I wouldn't take the ball back in an I formation. They've had a lot of success stopping the Trojan tailbacks tonight.
Well, they ran Peely. Ipo Peely came out, number 95. He's 325 pounds, and Daniel Marquardt is 315 pounds. So they got a lot of stuff in the middle. And Beach changed his mind, and he's going to send Tom Malone out and let him punt it away.
I think seeing big Ifo Pele scared him off it.
Well, you can't miss him. He's a whopper. And timeout now called. And maybe BYU doubts that the Trojans are really going to punt. But they'll talk about things. It's 21-12, 9-point lead USC.
If you're feeling sad and lonely.
Hello, Info. Can you find me another flight home?
Call me.
Hello, Info. I'm looking for Hollywood, the restaurant.
Hello, Info. Is my 2 o'clock at 2 or 2:30?
Hello, Info. I'm lost and I need directions.
Wherever, whenever you find yourself in need, don't just make a call. Make an Info call. Sign up is free at info.com.
Thank you so much.
Chili's baby back ribs. To go.
I think it's going to be about a yard short. Bring it up fourth and one.
Get in, get out, get on with your life.
We want to make sure that you're right for our daughter. Are you safe? Reliable?
Carfax has the history of the car you're looking at. Get a Carfax report from your dealer or go to Carfax.com and get the truth about used cars.
Catch the new show everyone's coming out for.
Even gay people must think you're gay.
It's All Relative. Series premiere Wednesday, October 1st on ABC.
Well, the Trojans had everybody thinking route after the first quarter of play, but BYU has slowed the roll. Five and by halftime, they had five, and here in the third quarter, they've got seven, and now they will punt. Tom Malone punting for the Trojans. And it's David Christensen waiting for it, standing back at his 10-yard line. Now he creeps up a little bit. And Malone's punt is another beauty. Oh, this has got coffin corner all over it, and they can't quite get it. They had a chance to knock it down at about the 2. And it goes into the end zone. Come out for the 20. ABC Sports presentation of college football. Brought to you by Chrysler Pacifica. Well beyond the SUV. FedEx. You can always rely on the ultimate in reliable shipping. Relax. It's FedEx. Total cereal. One bowl, 100%. And ADT. America's leader in business and home security. ADT. Always there. Let's see what BYU can do here. They've been pretty feisty in the third quarter. Carrying the ball is Tahi. And he picks up almost 2 yards. ESPN Original Entertainment's critically acclaimed drama Playmakers continues Tuesday at 9 p.m. Eastern and Pacific on ESPN. Playmakers also available in high definition on ESPN HD. For more information, log on to ESPN
carfax.com. Second down and eight. Perry's pass thrown to the outside, complete to Vakapuna, and he's got a first down. Up over the 30 to the 33, and we're off to visit with John.
Oklahoma in a tight one on the road to Tuscaloosa, but Jason White drops back, rolls one way, looks back the other, then spots his man deep, 47 yards. Brandon Jones, who takes a hit right at the goal line, but carries it in. Oklahoma with a little bit of breathing room, but still in a tough one against the Tide, 2010, Pete.
Well, that's an interesting matchup. It really is. Alabama, they're not without players. They've got talent in that football game. But in a couple of years, those loss of scholarships will hurt them. Brathwaite carries on that play, and he gets it up to the 35, just over it. Time remaining third quarter, 5:15. BYU.
Brathwaite.
Time to get back in the hunt.
Yeah, excuse me, Keith. Brathwaite last week filling in for Whalen, who broke his foot in pregame warmups, really surprised some of the coaches and players with his burst. We've yet to see it tonight, but he has breakaway game-breaking speed.
Second down and seven. Ball is fumbled and recovered by BYU, but there's a big loss on the play. Chris Hale, they're trying to set up a reverse, and the ball came out and Chris Hale covered it.
Well, Brathwaite got in the way.
Yep.
He appeared to not know what to do on the play. Watch Brathwaite, number 11. Here comes 29 Hale, and Brathwaite causes this fumble. Lucky for him and the Cougars that Hale was able to dive back on it.
And it's third and 15 now. They got him. 25-yard line, maybe the 26. I mean, the big foursome up front were relentless. Frosty Rucker, who's new to the scene as a sophomore here at USC, but he's pretty rambunctious. And with Ramsey and Patterson and Cody, they make quite a group.
Yeah, and they forced Barry up into the pocket where he couldn't see number 80, Toby Christensen, who was wide open but very deep down the field.
Here's the punt by Payne. Low line drive kick, long. Runs Arbett all the way back to the 21-yard line. A little juke gets him 5 yards, and that's all he'll get. A sure tackle in the open field, and USC takes over at the 25. Monday night, Tampa Bay against the Philadelphia Eagles. Joan L. Michaels, John Madden, Lisa Guerrero in Philly for a rematch of last year's NFC championship game. That's Monday night at 6 p.m. here on ABC. Well, the Trojan defense getting its neck bowed here, starting to handle things a little better. They give the ball to Herschel Dennis, and the BYU defense, which is equally getting the hump up, stack him up short of the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, this game was supposed to be an offensive shootout, Keith, and defenses take that type of talk personal. Middle linebacker Mike Tanner in on that one. But again, this slanting front three of BYU is getting exceptional penetration tonight.
Ball is lobbed outside to Dominique Bird, the tight end, and Bird is down around the 29.
Has a heck of a tackle too by Colby Bockwolt. If he doesn't make this tackle, Bird rolls down the sidelines for a first down at least.
Alex Holmes having trouble with his back. Nobody knows how long he's going to be gone.
46 is Buckwolt. Watch how he dives out here and brings down the big tight end. Textbook tackle, getting that head in front of those legs.
Good way to lose your head. Showing blitz. Back out now. Liner throws it behind the receiver, and the receiver was well covered. It was Justin Wyatt, number 24.
But that's part of the illusion. They fake the blitz, they back out, they come with the blitz, they force, they dictate to SC where they're going to throw the ball to the hot receiver, and then they cover the hot receiver. This defense is getting it now. Talking to Mendenhall, he said that he only have about 30% of this defense in, but that 30% is well learned right now.
David Christensen waiting for Malone's punt. This will be his fifth of the night. Short was 36, the long was 59. Well, this is a howitzer, all the way back to the 13-yard line, and Christensen goes down on a knee as he makes the catch. They'll give him the 14-yard line. That was a beauty. That was 58 yards. Sunday, September 28, ABC, ex-juvenile delinquent from New York has one chance to redeem himself by becoming a cop in L.A. 10-8, Sunday, September 28, at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
Either you're talking about Tom Malone and that 58-yarder and how well he's doing tonight. Remember the free kick after the safety?
Yep.
Kicked it from the 20. BYU caught it at the 11. I think that's 69 yards, isn't it?
Yep.
Thank you, Mark Demento.
Mark's hand to that thing.
He was checking my math. He knew I was groping. That higher math always got me.
Little drop off inside to Brathwaite. And the Trojans will have none of it. Matt Grudegood was Johnny on the spot, and he whacked him. Boy, I mean, he leveled him.
Let's take a look at this from our camera that shows 80,000 or 70,000 people and all 22 of these ball players. But Brathwaite can't afford to hesitate like this. Catch the ball, go. Don't look for a place to run because number six, Matt Grudegood, is going to find you.
Ball is on the 17-yard line where it is second down and seven. This time everybody is in pretty tight. And the ball is thrown downfield. The ball is caught by Toby Christensen. And he's caught at the USC 40, but there is a penalty flag way over across the field.
There was movement before the ball was snapped. SC definitely moved, but the question was, were they induced?
Sides, defense. Penalty
applied. Whoa.
First down.
Remember we showed you how Christensen was open deep early and Matt Berry couldn't find him? Well, that time Christensen was his primary receiver and he found him with a huge play. Here's Christensen, number 80 right there. He's gone the corner route. Good move to the inside to get by Will Poole. And then exceptional speed and almost gets it all the way. First catch of the night for 44.
And the ball is on the 39-yard line. Trojan defense getting it put to him a little bit here. This is Brathwaite getting outside. There's your breakaway speed. They got him down at the 11-yard line. Finally, Darnell Bing with an angle ran him down.
And Darnell Bing's got a sore ankle. You see him limping on that right ankle. Hurt it against Auburn last week. Was questionable whether he would play tonight. No question about the speed and burst and lack of hesitation that time by Brathwaite. Fortunate for he and Barry, they didn't fumble this exchange.
Whoa.
That is a great grab by Brathwaite as he reached down and he's on his way.
Mike Ross is in now at strong safety replacing Bing. Matt Berry being chased. Throws into the end zone. No, out of bounds.
Oh, that is really close to a touchdown. Rod Wilkerson saying, hey, I got my foot in. You only need one foot in. I got that one foot in. Berry showing good elusiveness and speed. Keeping his eyes down the field. Let's see if Wilkerson got that foot in or not. No, he didn't.
He's on the chalk.
He got four toes in. The little toe was out.
Yeah, the field judge and the back judge were both right there, looking right down that line.
That's right. Great position. Great call. That happened so quickly.
Second down and 10 from the 11. BYU down by 9, trying to close the gap. They fake the reverse. Brathwaite keeps it. Tackle made by Will Poole at the 15-yard line.
I'm not so sure he shouldn't have given the ball to Chris Hale on that reverse. It always looked better after the fake of the handoff. It looked like the guy that he should have handed it to would have scored.
Time running out in the third quarter, and I think they'll let the clock expire. So after three, it's 21-12 USC. ABC Sports presentation of college football returns after this message and the word from our ABC station.
What do people see in the new Chrysler Pacifica?
I see a woman who knows how to relax.
I see a man who knows where he's going in the world.
I see a painter, a parent, an individual.
I see a mom and a dad who are completely behind their kids.
Introducing the Chrysler Pacifica, well beyond the SUV.
I will not be afraid of the dark.
I will not feel guilty leaving my dog alone.
I will know my children are safe.
I will finally be able to relax!
At ADT, we help more people feel safe in more ways than any other security company. A single ADT system can help protect your home and family from burglary, fire, and carbon monoxide at a price you can afford. Plus, save up to 20% on your homeowner's insurance. Call 1-800-ADT-ASAP.
If you've been injured in an accident...
Commercial.
So, what's for dinner?
Remember that cute little pink blouse that I was telling you about the other day? You know, the one with the thing... Turkey pot pie!
Fast forward your wife and skip recorded commercials.
Wow.
Now you can get a free Dish Player DVR from Dish Network with up to 100 hours of tapeless recording with free installation. Visit Radio Shack, Sears, or a local participating retailer. Or call 1-800-WOW-DISH.
We're on. Time to get messy.
Stylish. Sexy. Spectacular.
You want to know the secret to winning rigged again?
Johnny Depp does it again. He's as good as it gets.
This is supposed to be the big dance number.
I'm on!
You dig it?
I can dig it.
Once Upon a Time in Mexico. Rated R. Opens everywhere Friday.
K2 and you, the spirit of the Northwest.
Well, Bing, the strong safety, the freshman who won a starting job, has a high ankle sprain. And those things are just almost impossible to heal without just absolutely resting on.
Yeah.
And he's tweaked it again. Mike Ross has replaced him at the strong safety. On third down and 13 now for BYU as we go to the final quarter. The ball is thrown quickly to the outside, Justin Drury. Justin Drury early in the ball game had a catch just on that same play and made it work, but he is short of the first down. Now let's check in with John.
Keith, it continues to get worse for the Canes. Rand Carthon from 4 yards out, and he's barely touched going through a pile. The lead is now 33-10, 30 unanswered points. Meanwhile, Florida State will hold this one out over Maryland, up 35-10. About 8 minutes left in the game.
All right, back here in the Coliseum in Los Angeles, it is fourth down, BYU. The ball is on the 3-yard line.
They
fourth
may return
for a first down.
They should go for the field goal here.
You ought to take your points when you got a chance to get them.
Pearson trying to draw them off sides.
Call time.
Yeah, but I think you guys too late. Delay a game call here, which doesn't hurt BYU at all. Forces him back 5 yards, actually improves the angle for Matt Payne.
The delay of game occurred prior to the timeout. 5 yard penalty, fourth down.
And you know, Barry's lucky that the flag was thrown before he called the timeout, because that would have been a bad use of a timeout.
And Payne is on the field to take the 3 points. Oregon State disdained a field goal try the other night in Fresno and wound up getting beat. Steven Jackson had a big game for the Beavers. The quarterback did not, threw 5 interceptions, and Oregon State got beat. But if they had kicked that field goal in hindsight, oh, it's glorious, isn't it? It's 150%. But nonetheless, take the points when you can get them. This to make it a 21-15 ball game. It's a 26-yard try, and it's good. And so now BYU is within 6 points of Southern California with 14:03 to play in the game.
We got a problem up here. Tower 12, weather's moving it.
I'm heading up.
Do you have the right truck? Does your truck have a Duramax diesel? Does it have an Allison transmission? Silverado. It's the right truck from Chevy. The most dependable, longest lasting trucks on the road. Like a rock.
What do you think? It's perfect. That's exactly what I want.
What?
Except bigger.
What do you mean bigger?
Something really pops the eye. Maybe rubies alternating with the sapphires. More stones. Pave diamonds all the way around.
Life's little expenses. Another good reason to keep your car around. That's why at 75,000 miles, switch to Valvoline's MaxLife. Its added ingredients help prevent wear on critical parts.
Hey, this is nothing, guys. For the honeymoon?
At 75,000, time to switch to MaxLife.
Room service. Your grape nuts, sir.
It'd take 4 bowls of grape nuts to get the B vitamins in just 1 bowl of total.
That's a manly breakfast. Your raisin bran.
10 bowls to equal the zinc in total.
I'll keep the gym open. Your special K, Ms.
40 bowls to equal the calcium in total.
Late checkout this morning?
You need Total. It's got 100% daily value of 12 vitamins and minerals. No other leading cereal comes close.
Pull a Total,
I'll take Total.
Kitchen's just closed.
Total, Total Raisin Bran. 1 bowl, 100%.
There was one envelope I really hated to open every month, my wireless bill. Bad news either way. I mean, if I talked too much, I got slammed with overages. And if I talked too little, I wasted all those minutes I paid for. But those days are over, thanks to Rollover.
Only Singular lets you roll over unused anytime minutes so you avoid paying overages months you talk more. They're your minutes. Keep them. Singular has rollover on national plans and your choice of cool phones.
I call it my look at that cute little bill plan.
Come in to find out how Singular fits you best.
We're ready for our date with a movie star.
It's not we're with her, it's I'm with her.
I'm with her, a new comedy premieres ABC Tuesday, September 23rd.
Why so harsh?
It's a 21-15 ball game, and Gary Croton is running through the ranks on the BYU side of the field. He knows his team's in the hunt, and so does Pete Carroll. His team has done nothing since the first quarter when it led 21-0. And now they only lead by 6 points with 14:03 to play in the game. And there's another coach, I bet you, that's found a way to watch this. His name is Lavelle Edwards. He and Patty are in New York on a mission. I don't know how they're watching it, but I bet he figured out a way. And here's the return. Marcel Hoffman coming up across the 25 to near the 27. Goodyear Blimp, Spirit of America, providing aerial pictures tonight. 2003, the 105th anniversary of Goodyear, and the 78th for their blimp fleet. The cameraman is Fabian Ochoa.
Fabian.
Fabian. He's a good guy.
He's got to be from Hollywood.
No, no. I think he's North Hollywood. First and 10. Going to try to run it here with Herschel Dennis. He is the sophomore among this squad of running backs that USC has. The three people immediately behind him are all freshmen. 4 people behind him are freshmen.
Yeah, he got some playing time last year in that senior dominated backfield. And when he runs similar, learned a lot from Justin Fargas. He is a one cut and go guy. He sees the hole and he hits it.
Boy, old Justin's doing well with the Raiders, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Second down, 6. Back it goes to Dennis. Comes over the right side, gets a little help from his big buddies, and he's a yard short of his first down at 13-10 to play. And again, here's John with an update.
And Keith, don't count the Canes out just yet. Brock Berlin having a miserable night, but here he goes 26 yards to Kevin Beard, who is wide open. They go for a 2-point conversion. That is good. So now Miami has pulled to within 33-18. Keith.
Even if they should pull it out, they have suddenly had a glimpse at their mortality, haven't they?
And especially at home.
Yeah, at home.
Outplayed by the Gators. Gain of 5 yards.
Just short, as you can see. So it's going to be third down in just a few inches. There's the coaches' poll. And Oklahoma, Ohio State. So I wouldn't be surprised to see Ohio State drop a little. USC's not going to move up. There's no question about that. Michigan would be the team that I would move up if I were voting, frankly. I mean, they look powerful today, I thought.
And no trouble with the University of Houston.
I think Michigan is powerful. That's what I think.
We'll find out in two weeks in Eugene.
Yep. Oregon comes out in those lightning yellow uniforms.
Go Ducks.
They go for it. And they get it. That landed on the quarterback sneak. On third down and inches, and we'll have a first down for the Trojans up on the 37-yard line. At the conclusion of today's game, a Chevrolet player of the game chosen from each team, Chevrolet making a $1,000 contribution to each of the university's general scholarship fund. General scholarship fund. Going to bring the chains on again.
John Denny with a stop for the Cougars.
Boy, this appears to have been a first down.
I thought so.
By a long way. I need to recommend
first down
some surgery for these officials on that one. Look, get rid of those cataracts.
Hey, guys, you want my glasses? That operation is painless. Well, the problem was that the chains are all the way across the field. On the other, they're over here on this near side hash mark. That's a ways. So the ball is between the 37 and 38 yard hash marks. And first down for the Trojans. They lead 21 to 15. Leinert back looks, goes down on a lob to the sidelines. Mike Williams. They're saying he's out of bounds. And the official says nothing to it. And it's first down at the 40-yard line.
Nothing wrong with that left wrist on that one as he reached out with both hands and pulled it in. A perfectly thrown pass by Matt Leinert, his best pass of the night in a long time. Little stumble there, but look at how long those arms are. And he reaches it and gets that 1 foot barely in bounds.
Ball is just inside the 40. 12 and a half minutes to play in the ball game. 6-point lead for USC. Leinert looks up, throws again, hits his man. That's Dominique Bird, the tight end. Big, strong guy. That's another first down for USC at the 25-yard line. So now the Trojan offense shows a bit of life. But it's still passing primarily and not very good running.
Yeah, you got to go with what you do best. Right now, SC is having more success throwing the ball, giving their athletes a chance to make plays. Dominique Bird with his second catch. He goes 255 pounds, and he punishes tacklers.
Ball just inches short of the 25-yard line on the BYU side of the field. Trojans had a 21-0 lead in the first quarter, and it's been all BYU since then. But right here, USC trying to get something going, and they're stopped short of the line of scrimmage as Papinga nails Herschel Dennis.
Yeah, I think that's what it sounded like when he hit Herschel Dennis.
Papinga. Dennis has carried the ball 11 times tonight, and I think this amplifies their problems with the running game. He's gained 14 yards.
And if you remember back last year, they struggled early in the season with their running attack. And it wasn't until Justin Fargas got totally healthy that it started to pick up.
Second and 10. Ball thrown outside. The pass is completed to Whitney Lewis, who was in the ball game, another one of those freshman running backs, and he's going to have a yard or so. Not much. Lewis. BYU making them throw to that hot man, aren't they?
Yeah. Well, that's a big part of this Norm Chow offense is spreading it out to different receivers, and that time it was almost like a little pick play as Bird cleared the way for Lewis to get in behind for that short completion. No panic on those two faces right there.
Reggie Bush is in. Mike Williams is up there at the top of the picture. Along with Steve Smith. Smith's a pretty good catcher. He's going for the ball, and it's overthrown. He had his man on his hip, too.
Yeah, a little indecision there by Matt Leinart. On a quick three-step drop, he looked at first to Mike Williams, who was covered, and then Smith broke free. Number two at the top of the screen is going to get behind Chad Barney there, and the ball is overthrown by 10 yards.
Here's Ryan Killeen, a 41-yard field goal try, and this would be a very big 3 points. It would be a 9-point lead again. Missed it. Wide to the right at 10:27 to play in the ball game. 21-15 USC, and you're watching ABC Sports Championship Television.
So I got tickets to the game tomorrow night. I wasn't sure if you wanted to go.
Well, it doesn't sound like you want me to go.
What? Of course I want you to go. I just thought maybe, you know, with the crowd and all that.
You'd probably have a better time with Gary.
Gary? No.
Why don't you ask Gary? And we'll hook up on Saturday.
Okay.
If you're sure.
I'm sure.
Okay, bye-bye. You're in.
Yes!
I'm out! That's what you say.
The persistence of 135 years of experience. The performance that has enabled us to work with more than half the Fortune 500. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life.
Do you have the right truck? Introducing the 2004 Chevy Silverado, available with new Power Pack savings. Get this Silverado extended cab with a light-duty Power Pack, Vortec V8 heavy-duty trailering and more, and the Safe and Sound Power Pack, bucket seats, a Bose sound system, and more. Combine your Power Pack savings with cash back for a $4,000 total value on select models. Silverado, now available with Power Packs. It's the right truck.
One thing that can break up any party? A broken chip. Get Tostitos Gold. The Tostitos that are made extra thick. Perfect for hearty dips. Tastes so good, you never know who'll show up.
So, guy goes into a bar.
Tostitos Gold. The perfect chip for hearty dips.
A 21-15 ball game. Ryan Killeen there with a little chin whiskers. Time permitting, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental post-game report, scores and highlights. We got a highlight building right here. It's first down and 10, BYU. Their own 23-yard line. They trail by 6 points to Southern California. And this is Brathwaite trying to get to the outside, and there's a penalty flag thrown in the middle of the field at the line of scrimmage. Came from the umpire.
And you know what that means.
That's holding. It's against BYU while they mark it off. Here's John again with more about that Miami and Florida scuffle.
Well, it's been a struggle all night for Brock Berlin, but he's got it going now. This would be his 8th consecutive completed pass, and again to Kevin Beard to cover 62 yards. Looks like he gets into the end zone for the touchdown. They rule he was out at the 1. That just sets up Frank Gore, who takes it in. And now Miami, and they're not even in the fourth quarter right now, within 8.
Then they run out of light bulbs on the scoreboards where they get through. The holding call moves the football back to the 13-yard line now on BYU as they look at first down and 20.
Remember when Matt Berry went out of the game to watch John Beck play? I think it did him a lot of good, Keith, because yeah, he's really turned his game around, especially in the second half.
Yeah. Oftentimes that'll help. And it gives you a different perspective. Kobe Christensen coming down the middle of the field. He goes the other way with it. And the catch is made by Rod Wilkerson, and he's at the 19-yard line.
Pretty good determination by Berry. Remember, he's been sacked a bunch of times tonight, but he's a big, strong guy, 6'5", 227 pounds, hung in the pocket a long time without getting hit. Good pocket awareness, steps up just a bit there, and then finds Wilkerson for the completion.
And I think you Mountain West Conference guys better know this is a pretty good football team they got up there in Provo again this year. That ball is thrown to the right side, and again it is Wilkerson going for it and coming down with, no, it's Chris Hale, 29. And Chris Hale makes a good catch. He's the son of Val Hale, the athletic director, who's sitting next door.
So he's got a pretty good shot at getting some playing time, huh?
I would think.
Well, the other thing about him is he's pretty fast, too. So fast that time he trips over his own feet, or he might have picked up more yards, more valuable yards as they face this third and long.
I think Hale and Toby Christensen, there are a lot of guys out there that can run. Third down and 8. Barry has all day and hits his big tight end right on the hands, and he's rolling out of bounds on the SC 38-yard line. How in the world did Daniel Coates get that wide open?
Well, you said it, Keith. He had time to throw. He had about 5 seconds, the most he's enjoyed all night long. This offensive line is really controlling it now. SC comes with a safety blitz and Kevin Arbett. Here is Coates, number 20, all the way across the field. This takes a long time. Good catch as he reaches high to pull it in.
And it's first down BYU, and they're down knocking on the door. 36 yards on that play. 7 catches, 99 yards for Coates, and a touchdown. And this is Tahi. And he's got about 4 yards on that carry.
Certainly looked like there was movement before the ball was snapped. Tahi showed great movement after the ball was snapped with a couple of nice moves in the hole to pick up really an impressive 4-yard gain.
Coming up on 8 minutes to go in the ball game, 21-15. Very much unresolved at the moment. SC missing a 41-yard field goal to give him a 9-point lead just a few minutes ago. Ball's thrown hard down the middle and it's incomplete. Once again, Matt Barry is on his back. Toby Christensen was the man he was trying to find down the middle. And Sean Cody was the man that put the whack on the quarterback.
Well, they're bringing Matt Grotegood and Jason Leach, and Grotegood unloads on the quarterback. But that's a big part of Pete Carroll's scheme, is to bring 4 men from the weak side where the you only have 2 or 3 blockers to pick them up.
Yeah, Grotegood took him down and Cody jumped over him. Matt didn't have anything to do with his going down. Sean Cody. This is Chris Hale in the traffic. And the Trojans lasso him at about the 34-yard line.
They just have too much quickness on defense for that type of play. That's the wide receiver screen. And by bringing it all the way back into the middle, as they're trying to do here, watch the pursuit of SC. I mean, that's where all the big guys are. You don't want to run in there.
It's 4th and 6. Field goal try now. 52 yards by Matt Payne. He's good from 53, missed from 54, and good here. So he's good from 52 and 53 tonight. And he has halved the Trojan lead. It is now 21-18 with 7:05 to play.
We should change before we pick up the girls. Okay.
Chevy Avalanche. It changes from a pickup to an SUV.
What are you doing?
Avalanche, like a rock.
There's a fine line between pleasure and pain. Your muscles will let you know when you've crossed it. Introducing new 8-Hour from Tylenol with 2 layers. One that's fast, one that lasts. All day, one dose. New 8-Hour from Tylenol. Because when you push your muscles this hard, you're gonna need pain relief that lasts this long. Eight Hour. It's the new Tylenol for muscle pain.
Introducing Taco Bell's new spicy chicken burrito. Packed with shredded chicken, simmered in Mexican spices, loads of seasoned rice, and zesty fiesta salsa. It's a little spicy. Taco Bell's new spicy chicken burrito, just $1.29. To get your fill of this satisfying thrill, think outside the bun.
Hey, old guy, your show's coming to the new TGIF. What are you going to do now?
Just taking a little fart walk.
Married to the Kellys premieres Friday, October 3rd, part of the all-new TGIF on ABC.
SC scored 21 points to lead in the first quarter, 21-0. BYU has come back with 18 unanswered points, and now they will kick off after the field goal, trailing by 3 points. Southern California sending Reggie Bush back there, but is he going to get to it? No. It's going to go to Marcel Aumann. And Marcel Aumann finds some daylight. A wideout turned quarterback and kick returner, and he gives the Trojans great field position all the way out past the 40-yard line.
And isn't it amazing how many times a kick returner will fumble the ball around, finally pick it up, and then rip off a big gain? It kind of distracts the coverage team. They're thinking, hey, we're going to get to this ball, so they come out of their lanes and get pinned to the inside. That gives Aumann the outside and good field position for the Trojans.
On the 43-yard line. That's Kerry Colbert in motion. Leinert keeps it, pressure on, and throws incomplete. And he gets knocked down. The pressure was coming from Kip Nielsen. The man rolled out thinking he'd be out by himself and have time to do a little shopping, but suddenly there was a white shirt right in his face.
You know, I think the maturity level, this against BYU, a costly penalty.
Where was the flag? I never saw it. Way on the far side of the field.
Yeah. These players are mature.
Defensive holding.
Yeah, and they're a lot older. They're not going to get flustered. They're down 21. They just kept fighting. And the penalty is going to be on number 46 there. That's Kobe Buchwald. I'm not so sure that that's defensive holding, though. There's the flag. That's a very questionable call against Buchwald.
It's a first down over on the BYU side, then 47-yard line with Chauncey Washington in the backfield for USC. Another one of those freshmen. He didn't get much out of it, a couple of yards. Both teams with a lot of freshmen playing a lot now. 6 minutes and 35 seconds to go in the ball game. 21-18, and I don't think very many people expected this. Reading a lot of the columns in the newspapers over in Utah about this game, and I didn't read anywhere where any of those guys over there thought their team could come over here and have a chance to win.
A lot of them were talking about, will BYU be shut out for the first time?
Yeah.
You know, you see that as a headline, you know things aren't good.
Nope. Herschel Dennis is the beat back. Leinert stands up and lobs it in the air for Mike Williams, and Williams makes the catch. And they're going to give him the catch. Boy, I mean, he is right on the sideline when he comes down. And it's about the 32-yard line in front of Chad Barney. And Chad is not happy.
Well, in front of the SC bench, you know, the officials had help on this one. But he's in.
He's in.
That right foot is in. Does he have field awareness? Two great catches by Mike Williams tonight, dancing on both sidelines.
Make it the 31-yard line where it's first and 10, 6:01 to play in the ball game. They'll run it with Dennis. And Herschel will have about 5 yards, and here's another penalty flag. This one comes from this side. Field judge threw it. Crack back block, chop block against the Trojans.
And that's only the fourth penalty against SC, but that's a crucial one because they were gaining momentum. They were getting the big play by Mike Williams. That was a good run by Herschel Dennis.
Both coaches, every coach on both sidelines, boy, they worked hard tonight.
They've been through a few shirts,
oh,
huh?
Oh, man. Well, that's a big penalty. Might be called a drive killer here.
Well, for one thing, it forces them out of field goal range. It happened on first down, so they have some downs to make it back. But with number one on the sidelines, hopefully just getting a rest. Remember, he hurt his left wrist in the first half.
Spot a foul penalty, so you got a 4-yard gain, you got a 15-yard penalty, you got a first and 21 now. Colbert, pitch it back to Dennis. And Herschel Dennis gets some of it back as he gets inside. Appointed by the President of the United States, smart, sexy, lethal, it says here from Danny DeVito and Elmore Leonard comes U.S. Marshal Karen Sisko. Premieres after The Bachelor on Wednesday, October 1st at 10, 9 Central on ABC. And a lot of these gun-toting ladies on television, aren't we?
I think that was a gymnastics show.
Pistol-packing mama. 38-yard line. Second down and 17. And whistle stop him. Timeout. Kerry Colbert was calling the timeout on the far side of the field for some reason.
You know, Mike Williams can throw the ball. That was a backward pass to him from Leinart. And I got a feeling that he was ready to load one up, throw it down the field himself.
Up your night for Outback's legendary Bloomin' Onion and our center cut filet.
Hey, John, how's work?
Working as we speak.
Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
We got a situation. What's your 20?
I'm there.
Do you have the right truck? Does your truck have a big block Vortec V8 and an Allison transmission? Does it have the most torque of any gas-powered heavy-duty pickup? Silverado. It's the right truck from Chevy. The most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
We started this thing! And now that we're on top, everybody's trying to knock us off. It's us! Versus them. We must protect this house. Will you protect this house?
I will. I will.
Under armor. We must protect this house.
Southern California leading by 3 points at 4:49 to play in the game. On the football on the BYU 38-yard line. It's a moment of tedium for the Trojan faithful. The ball thrown in the middle to Williams. First down at the 18-yard line. I mean, Mike Williams is a gamer.
Yeah, and being 6'5", and having the ability to go up in the air, shield the ball with his body, keep it away from the defender. This is pitch and catch. In front of Aaron Francisco, who's not a small guy himself at 6'2", but you can see the ball thrown high. It's just impossible for Francisco to make a play on it.
Clock is running at 4:20. Williams is the man in motion. Leinart keeps it. Left-hander throws it. Man wide open. Williams, touchdown. Absolutely perfect execution of the play.
And a perfect play design by Norm Chow. Bring Williams across the formation in motion and then let him sift his way through the defense, getting totally lost with the misdirection. The bootleg just killed BYU.
Easier when your guy's a left-hander, too. Killeen for the point. Good. And so some of the high drama drains away. It is now a 10-point lead for USC. But there's still 4:11 to play in the game.
There goes Williams in motion. The movement back here. And now look at this area that is wide open for Mike Williams to find.
That left wrist didn't hurt him at all.
Williams with 10 catches tonight, 8 last week. He's over 126 yards for the evening and 2 touchdown receptions and the ball in that sore left wrist as he breaks the plane.
Matt Leinart's pretty happy too.
Yeah, he's got a go-to guy in a big way. 99 career receptions now for number one. One away from 100. And he's just in his second game of his second season.
What a well-spoken, good-looking young guy he is. Plant High School in Tampa, Florida. Plant may be at least as popular for the baseball players that it's produced over the years as it is football.
You know, and he's had to adjust to a left-handed quarterback after catching 88 from Carson Palmer last year. Says the ball spins a little bit differently, but the ball's usually on target for Matt as well.
The kickoff by Killeen is 5 yards deep into the end zone, and David Christensen is coming out. And he would have been better off to let it go. He'd be out at the 20 instead. He's camped at about the 16. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Budweiser. Grab a cold, fresh Budweiser. It's game time. Chevy Silverado, it's the right truck. And Taco Bell, think outside the bun. .406 now remaining, and it's from the 16. Matt Berry has 3 wideouts at the top of your picture. Pressure coming. First man missed him. Now he's got some time to shop. Now he throws back into the middle of the field to Daniel Coke. And Coke shakes one. 3-4-5 get him at the 32, but it's a first down, and Berry is down. Matt Berry is down on the field, the BYU quarterback.
Yeah, he was scrambling for his life, looking for his go-to guy, number 20, Matt Leinart. Daniel Coates. He finds him over the middle, and he takes a shot from Lawan Ramsey that laid him out. Remember, Ramsey had a big game against Auburn. There he is, 52, with a shot right under the arm. And the first thing that hits is the back of Matt Berry's helmet.
John Beck hurrying up, warming up as best he can, rushed into the game as Berry has to come out after the injury.
Last time he was in the game, he was 21-0. SC, now he's in the game, he's down 10. All he has to do is get 10 quick ones with only 2 timeouts to work with.
Beck out of the shotgun. Little bit quicker, maybe. Here's the ball thrown down the sidelines, and it is out of bounds, incomplete. Here's John Saunders with another update.
Keith, in your game, BYU almost got all the way back, and Miami has done the same. Brock Berlin, 6 yards to Ryan Moore. He goes across for the touchdown. They got a celebration penalty, so that took them out of range to go for the 2-point conversion. So they take the single and now trail by one, 33-32. When your game is over, much of you will get a chance to see the end of this Florida-Miami game. Keith.
Well, remember who you're dealing with now. They throw the ball out west, John.
And Matt Berry's going to be throwing it, Keith.
Berry's back into the ball game, having shaken the cobwebs out after the hit. He's going big time. Down the sidelines, intercepted. Will Poole intercepts it. He couldn't throw it far enough. Or at least he didn't throw it far enough.
Yeah, it's the second time he's tried to unleash one down the field, and both times he has underthrown the ball. A little bit out of spiral. You got to wonder about that hit by Lawan Ramsey, if it had an effect on the arm strength of Matt Berry, because Hale has a shot. He's got two steps on Poole, but Poole with great reaction. And how about that leaping ability? Wow.
Will played very well last week in the Auburn game as well, and makes a huge play here tonight. And the Trojans now take over with 3:29 to play in the game. Give it to Reggie Bush. Reggie Bush is a freshman. He learns every day. And he's one of those kind of guys, when he turns the corner, he's running downhill. And he can really pop you.
Let's go back to that hit by Lawan Ramsey on Matt Berry and just see when he hits the ground if he does land on his right arm or not. A little bit on that right shoulder. Big hit by Ramsey, clean hit, and a painful one for Matt Berry.
So it is second down and six now as the Trojans try to kill the clock. There's a penalty flag. Very little gain on the play as BYU's number 77, Daniel Marquardt, sends Herschel Dennis reeling the other way.
Pete Carroll can't believe it, but the Trojans were offside.
Prior to snap, dead ball foul, ball start, offense, 5 yards, remains second down.
Well, everybody's getting a little tired now, because they have not been able to rotate maybe as many people as they had hoped to. Fatigue may be getting into it.
Yeah, I think you're right, Keith. And now, if you're BYU, you're going to see all types of pressure. They're going to be crowding the line of scrimmage. They'll bring 8, 9 up to that line of scrimmage. Interesting to see if SC spreads them out with 3 and 4 wide receivers to prevent them from trying to get more people to the ball. But SC goes with 2 tight ends.
Going to get the first down in that kind of traffic. So it'll be third down, 11. The ball is around third down and 9. The ball around the 35-yard line. Clock stops now on the timeout at 2:15 to play in the game.
Sunday, September 28th, ABC presents television's most anticipated premieres at 8, 7 Central.
Ready for this?
God, I hope so.
A new drama, 10, 8, Officers on Duty at 9, 8 Central.
You were missing for almost 2 years.
A whole new season begins. Alias at 10, 9 Central.
I'd be such a natural here.
Jane Spader joins this Emmy winner for an explosive new season, The Practice. Sunday, September 28th, ABC puts on Sunday's Best.
This is Miami. It's got a rhythm. It's got a beat.
I'm a marshal. I catch the bad guys and I put them away.
And wherever you go, you'll feel the heat.
I really like catching the bad guys.
From executive producer Danny DeVito and Elmore Leonard comes a new style of drama that's pure Miami. Karen Sisko, ABC Wednesday, October 1st.
Oh, a lot of guys have spent a lot of effort tonight. Somebody's going to lose. The attendance tonight, 75,315.
Good crowd.
Stay on the ground with it. Run that clock. BYU now has 1 timeout remaining, and they'll spend it probably right here. Both these teams, we mentioned earlier, with a lot of young people, freshmen, some many true freshmen playing. Talk to Pete Carroll about playing freshmen, redshirting freshmen, and here's what he said.
I don't want to set the ceiling on a kid's potential without even having the opportunity to compete. So I don't think that way, and I don't let our coaches think that way. We try to force our guys along so that they can play right away. I would like to have played more guys in this first game. But by the next 3 weeks, we'll have played quite a few guys, and they're competitively and athletically good enough to compete, so they need to be out there.
That came out of the conversation regarding John David Booty, who graduated from high school early and is competing for playing time at quarterback. So they get younger and younger.
Yeah, because they leave sooner and sooner to the NFL. So you've got a player who's good enough to play as a freshman. You better play him as a freshman because he may not be around when he's senior.
That's right. That's Booty right there. He's a big guy. He can throw a hummer. He's pretty good. You know how refreshing it is? I've got to say it once, but I haven't mentioned Maurice Clarett once.
Nice change from last week.
Here's the putt. Oh, this Malone has had himself a night. Look at this. Look at this. He's going to kill it at the 5-yard line. He hit a 3-iron and he stuck it. 55-yard punt, and he killed it on the 5-yard line with backspin. He's gone 36, 59, 50, 54, 58, and now 55.
And don't forget the 69-yarder on the free kick.
After the safety, yeah.
At least he's been going great through the whole camp, but I tell you, he's really having himself a start on a season.
And if it wasn't for Mike Williams, he might be the player of the game.
He might. Of course, he'd have to beat out Omar Nazel.
Here's your screen. And it is going to be short of the first down. The ball may have come out. It did. Southern California has recovered it. And at 1:45 to go in the ball game, and BYU with no times out remaining, Matt Grootegood covers the fumble by Tahi. And maybe the lights just went out for the BYU Cougar.
Looks like Kevin Arbett, number 30, comes up. And that ball was out before he hit the ground. Grootegood almost picked it up to score. Or was he?
So,
Kevin Arbett.
That's a tough way to go down, but it goes down as a result of trying to do something. Ball came out when he went down.
Yeah. First thing that hit is the ball.
So a minute 45 to play in a ball game, and now all they've got to do is just run the clock, and Dennis will take it into the end zone, and that will really do it. So I'm sure part of the will may have gone out of the Cougars on that turnover, and USC cashes it in on the first play, and this party, for all intents and purposes, is over.
And it shows you the value of punter Tom Malone and how well he punted tonight and pinned the Cougars deep here. But you know, this final score will impress the pollsters, but if you watch this game, you knew that SC had to really struggle after jumping out to that big lead, going totally flat, and then coming back late.
It was a fight.
That is the third touchdown the Trojans have scored off of BYU turnover tonight. Now the point try to make it a 35-18 ball game.
Good. Yeah, you know, Gary Croton's got to be proud of his football team. A real gutty performance by the Cougs to come back from 21 down and really put it to the Trojans.
The executive producer of ABC Sports is Mike Pearl. Senior producer is Bob Toms. Coordinating producer of college football, Bob Goodrich. Our producer here in Los Angeles tonight, Mark Loomis. Our director, Derek Mumbly. Our associate producer, Jeff Kibler. Associate director, Betsy Aronin. Technical director, John Zippe. Production assistant, Kurt Thomas, Joe Zucco. Our production manager, Joe Alvarado, and technical manager, Al Fong. Mark Amedo on our stats, and Kelly Hayes, our spotter. And Kelly's off to the wars in Philly, along with Mark. Well, have a good trip. Better thee than me, lad.
They're getting that frequent flyer mileage build up, aren't they?
Yep. Studio show producer Tim Weinkopf, Calvin Haywood, director, technical director Kevin Beeman. Bierman and John and Terry Bowden, John Saunders, Terry Bowden. And we're waiting to switch you over to Miami and Florida. That has turned into a dinger.
And here's BYU trying to get something going up the field to about the 20-yard line. The most valuable players, Chevrolet players of the game. Daniel Coates for BYU, 8 catches, 114 yards and a touchdown. Mike Williams for Southern California, 10 catches, 126 yards and 2 touchdowns. Todd Harris, who's our man reporting from down on the field as usual. Dan Fouts, our analyst.
Careful now. And the legend continues, Keith Jackson.
And it's been fun being with you.
And it's great to have Miss Turian in the booth with us as well.
John Beck is the quarterback now for BYU, and he takes off. John isn't going to get very far. He's up close to a first down around the 30-yard line. Down by Frosty Rucker. A 35-18 ball game. 1:05 left to play here at the Coliseum in Los Angeles. Started out very hot. It was in the 90s today and in the middle 80s, I think, probably when we started the ball game around 5 o'clock and went. The temperature dropped down. It's been very comfortable this evening. The only thing wrong was with the day is the Coliseum elevator wasn't working. And Dan tells me there are 82 steps. From down below up to here, and the ball comes out again, and here may be another turnover.
Somebody's got to get to John Beck and say, you're not going to beat the Trojans or get points on the board by you running. You're going to get killed. Luckily, a Cougar jumped on his fumble there.
Down prior to loss of possession of the ball. First down, BYU.
Oh, they get a first down out of it just over the 40-yard line. And we hope that you have a nice, robust thunderstorm around your house up in Sisters, Oregon. Help control that fire that's still raging. John Beck is being helped off the field. So the BYU quarterbacks have had their problems tonight. Berry has been out a couple of times injured, and now we're going to get a third quarterback into the ball game. That would probably be Todd Mortensen, number 14. So Berry's out, Beck is out, and Mortensen is in. Beck looks all right, but we know for a fact that he took a pretty good lick over there. Mortensen really had no time to warm up. He throws a long one down the sidelines. It is a little bit too high. Good defense over there by Will Poole. Poole made an interception over there a little while ago.
Yeah, sometimes you learn your lessons the hard way. This is the hard way. Dallas Sartz with the shot on Beck, and Beck may have been out before he hit the ground.
It'll be second and 10, the clock stopping at 22 seconds to play in the ball game. BYU's continuing its string of scoring. It'll be 352 games as of this one. That's an NCAA record. And this is Thomas Stansel carrying for the Cougars. That gets your clock going, and I think that'll do it. With your final score going into the book at Southern California 35 and Brigham Young University 18. And we're down now to 2.5 seconds. And for some reason they chose not to let the game end. It's over.
Pete definitely thinks it's over. There's a flag on.
Non-contact foul on the defense. Players entered the field as BYU was getting ready to snap the ball. It is 15-yard penalty.
My goodness. Well, now at 2.5 seconds to go, you might as well throw it in the end zone and see if you can get six.
Well, what happened is the Trojans were counting down with everybody else, not expecting BYU to try to even snap the ball. I'm not sure BYU was even going to snap the ball. They got called for too many men on the field.
Mortensen back. Oh, he just swings it out to the side at 2.5 seconds. This game's over right there. Final score is USC 35. Trojans continue undefeated, having beaten Auburn and BYU 35-18. ABC Sports Online, ESPN.com, keyword ABC Sports. And now here's John Saunders, Terry Bowden in Times Square Stadium.
Thanks a lot, Keith. So USC goes to 2-0 on the season. Now, the big question mark in the big game.